puzzle.
Oh shit. Okay, wait.
Need to hide those. You're not supposed to see them yet.
No.
Okay, I'm gonna.
Okay, my only problem right now is that I have everything in the middle of the ground, so if I want to get out of my computer later, I have a maze to go past. Get all of this up on top of the computer. This is
okay.
My project
can
for
I
the weekend.
Mute my
on
microphone
Saturday,
for a sec,
I'll be
back.
Getting this
okay.
Computer working. Okay.
No.
Okay.
Okay.
Get out of the floor.
Oh
fine.
No! Get on the floor.
No.
It's the fucking.
Yeah, I love that song actually. Don't fuck with my heart.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, never make me hum. I'm really bad at it. Okay, unboxing done. I'll be highlighting that separately. And now I need to see if everyone is actually around. Did Ringo say that he's gonna BRB quickly?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think he's doing his stream intro.
Oh yeah. So while he's at that one, I will quickly fetch myself a drink right behind my laptop. And from the apparently this is almost empty, so I'll be going to the fridge quickly.
Now it's playing in my head. Aww.
Who left the scissors in the floor? God damn it. Damn you pesky me. Back. But yeah, you can put Mickey O'Neill back to full health if you want. He's already fully rested. Everyone.
Oh, I did.
Yeah, apparently yours is still on zero, so.
Current HP. 8.
You can just click your character and write on the green circle just to put like a plus something or
yeah.
Your maximum health.
Okay, I'm gonna zoom out a little bit.
Yeah, maximum health without the plus.
On the plus side?
On the minus side, my head hurts.
Also, remember to fill up your spell slots and everything. It has been like a week since the last mission. You've been doing other things in the meanwhile.
Oh, well then, I have to think what I've been doing.
Don't worry, I'll have you covered if you need it.
I'm like,
hello.
I don't trust you. I don't trust you, Lukdari.
There's only one person I don't trust here.
Wait, what?
It's yourself.
We were talking about this. Lukdari said that it's been a week since our last adventure.
Lukatari has been weak.
No.
In time.
Our last. In time in our game.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's been a week.
Yeah. In real time, it has been a week, but also in game time, it has been a week since the last mission.
Okay, so we had our rest.
You've had your downtime. You've done your shopping that you've done in the meanwhile with the money you've gotten.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
You've done other smaller things that have enabled you to actually eat for the week without having to take that out of your pay. So don't worry about that. And during this week, you've gotten small, pretty useless missions, but you've always been doing them with different adventurers, and maybe one or two you've done with the same group, with some of the members. but you haven't had a real mission in a full week now, after the last one.
Okay.
That's the starting point of this now.
Yeah, just those, what are those side quests in MMO RPGs?
Right.
Just the fetch and...
My poor Skittles, the cat has gone away.
Kill the rats.
Bring him back.
So, do we have time to say like, hey, how's everyone doing, or do you guys want to start?
Up to you.
Yeah, so anyways, it's been a week. How have you guys been doing? Are we role-playing maybe, or are we doing like... No, let's... I'm interested in you guys. How are you guys doing today, in real life?
My head hurts.
That's a good start.
Yo, last week was my head that hurt.
I'm still poor.
Oh shit. Does that mean next week somebody else's head is gonna hurt?
Oh shit. Okay. Place your bets now.
Holy shit, my head is starting to hurt now.
Okay, I won the bet. No,
How does
what
it
was
work?
That, Ornstein? You said you were still poor?
Yeah, I'm still poor.
It's gonna be lucky.
Well.
It's gonna be Lucky that has a headache. Oh shit, no, I have to roll a d6.
D5? What the hell is a d5?
Yeah, okay.
Oh shit, it's gonna be me.
Yes. You're fine with that?
I don't care.
Okay. Well,
I feel shit already, I don't care.
No, I seriously never care whenever I get a headache.
Where the fuck did you get a d5 from?
You can just rolling.
Yeah, you can do slash roll 1d5.
Mm-hmm.
You can even do like slash roll, like 2000, whatever.
Oh wow, whatever. That's an awesome roll! Oh my god!
Holy fuck!
Fucking
time. This is please don't do that again.
You can roll whatever you want. This is like. The poor man's clear chat.
Hang on, be right back. I need a drink.
Yo, enjoy.
Oh my god.
Oh, did you really?
Really?
No.
Wow.
No. Ornstein misspelled his thing. It says D100.
Rolling D100.
Oh, yeah.
Not necessarily 1D100.
That's the D1. But it's still a critical fail.
You had a one in 20 chance to be a loser.
Not really. One out of one.
Okay.
Rolling D1.
It really is quite scary how you roll that just like Jerry. You are the famous roller in the world.
If this shit doesn't stop, I swear to God, I'm drug cocks all over the map.
No. Okay.
Critter fumble is both at the same time, I guess.
It's a critting fumble.
Yeah.
Okay.
For me, last week has been a tiring one. Back to work, my vacation was over. But just today, I got my computer. I was unboxing it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, shit. What kind of graphics card do you have?
I have the GTX 1080 Titan Edition.
Oh, shit. Really? Nice.
And I have a terabyte sized SSD hard drive.
That's insane.
Wow. Yo, that's a lot of money, dude. That's gonna be like 1 terabyte SSD. That's gonna be at least like
150 euros.
150 euros for a 1 terabyte SSD?
Yeah. The fuck was that from?
Nah.
Yeah, this whole computer in total was about 2,150,
dude. That's like nothing. Wait. I'm gonna check the Dutch website, Price Watch.
SSDs have gone down in price, Ringo.
Yeah, but not to the point. Okay, wait. Opslag, which means. What's it mean? Put your memory on, hard disks. Okay, solid state drives. So this one is 500 GB, is 170 euros.
Holy shit.
Yes! Okay, wait. Storage, yes, exactly, Papercup, storage! I can talk to the stream right now, but if we actually start playing the game, we have to be, I won't be able to talk in chat, or voice chat, because, immersion. Gotta talk with my robot role and be like, hello,
Yeah, if you spoil my version, I'm gonna stab you in the kidney.
Oh shit, dude.
Actually, I think it might have been a bit more expensive than that. Maybe 300 euros.
Yeah,
I remember wrong. Yeah, also to my chat, I won't be interacting with the chat too much. At least I won't be talking aloud. I will be most likely writing a few letters here and there.
Oh, no, no, I won't be able to be in your chat. I was like, oh, maybe I should check join your chat. But I'm like, no, wait, people can, you know, check out your stuff. So.
Yeah, I also need to...
We have this thing called... Well, for me, it's exclamation mark Lukishiba, because Lukitari plus, you know, Ring Shiba. We have this multi-stream. For the people that are on my stream, Lukitari is streaming too. If you want to click on that link, you can see both of our streams. Do note that he is playing as a DM. He knows everything, and he has, like, you know, like... Just don't spoil it for the other people, please.
Yes. Basically, my side is the DM side. I have my DM notes all over the map sometimes, telling where are secrets and what is hidden everywhere and stuff like that. On Ringo's side, as long as Ringo has light during cave dive and so on, you will be only able to see what he is seeing. And that might be limited in some areas, but it's way more interesting in a way, because then you would know what's going to happen next.
Yes.
Shara has been doing charity. She made food for orphans and urchins.
I've got to buy whiskey. I completely forgot.
Did you guys get your snacks and drinks and stuff like that? I got my Pepsi Max Lemon. Not that much anymore, but I still have a bottle. Ooh, holy shit, that's loud.
Oh, shit.
That was loud.
Yeah.
That's almost like me.
That was beautiful.
I already drank my Monster Energy.
Let me do this too.
Okay.
Oh, my God!
There you go.
I got my beer. What do you guys drinking? Drink?
I just got
Coke
myself...
Coke Zero, man.
Oh, shit.
I got myself a peachy thing. Peach. I'm not sure what it is. It's something that tastes like peach. It's good.
It's a peachy drink for children.
Mm-mm. It's not for children. It's like those sports drinks.
Parker won't work for... wait.
Okay. I'm ready whenever.
How much is one whiskey?
One whiskey? What do you mean?
In-game, how much is one?
What was the list we used in the early times of our Finnish game?
One whiskey?
One whiskey? What do you mean?
You know, fuck it, I'm just gonna say it's 10 silver because I have no fucking idea how much it actually costs.
Just a moment! I have a book here. I will be grabbing it.
Weren't you supposed to buy everything like during downtime?
I forgot.
You knew.
Around here.
I was gonna buy that item I can use for my identification spell, but nobody wanted to give me 50G.
Oh no.
Because the thing that I needed was 50G.
Well, okay, then you're okay, just gonna have to wait until you get more money.
I first identify.
Okay, food, drink, and lodging. You wanted to have a whiskey.
Yep, I want to have several whiskey.
There is wine.
This dude is gonna be the drunken
one. I guess the closest one would be wine. There's no whiskey separately.
Aww.
There is ale, and then there's wine.
Fuck it, I'll have ale. How much is one ale?
Do you want a mug or a gallon?
Yo, dude.
I think it's like a
bottle. I want a bottle of ale, man.
There is no bottle. There's a gallon or a mug.
A gallon.
Okay, gallon is two silver pieces each. And gallon is a lot.
Yeah, dude. Pathfinder has.
Pathfinder has.
Pathfinder whiskey. Look at this. Okay, Black Hill whiskey, Chilaxian pepper whiskey, Dragon Punch whiskey, Dragon Scar whiskey. Fish oil whiskey, no whiskey, Yanderhof whiskey.
Where are you from?
Old Erebus.
Did we just say no whiskey?
And throat burn. Oh shit, man.
Pathfinder wiki.
Yeah.
No.
A very potent whiskey. Throat burn is made of the gnomes of Khalsgard. Oh, by the gnomes, not made of. That would be weird. Anyways.
So shall we get started then?
Yes. 10 silver to 1 gold, yeah?
Really?
I gotta check my voice. Okay, what mood am I in? Am I? Wait, hello, this is my voice. Do I want to be higher or lower?
Hello, this is...
No. This is my voice, yes.
That's that better.
It's my robot voice.
I think the high pitch is better.
High pitch, yeah. I could also be like, hello, this is my one.
No, actually, not at...
That sounds like some guy that's like that wants to be anonymous, you know, but doesn't really sound like a robot. I think this sounds more like a robot. That's
Are you a
better.
Hacker known as Anonymous?
Okay, guys, let's go.
Okay. So yeah, you have been doing things for a week. As already mentioned in the chat, Sarah has been doing charity. She made food for the orphans and urchins and been donating money for those as well, caring for the poor people. And the other of you, what has been Ringo doing during this week? Being a warforce and everything. Ringo has been turned off for a week.
I've been turned off for a week, so I didn't do anything. My character went to recharge.
You have a poor block, so it took you a whole week to actually recharge. Especially since there's no electricity in this world, so...
Oh, right, I just... My character... Wait, I gotta read my story again. See if I have...
Oh, Ringo has been turned off for a week!
Damn!
Aww.
Wait...
You need to get your libido back.
Wow, that was beautiful. I don't know, nothing much that I did. I've been reading books and trying to be a real boy. just like Pinocchio. I'm gonna be a real boy soon.
O'Neill has spent 10 gold on a massive piece up and further 2 gold on fixing his liver. What?
that's quite cheap for fixing his liver.
Yeah,
a little bit too cheap, I think.
Magic, man. Fuck off, I'm not spending more gold on my fucking liver.
I will sell your liver, man.
Can I sell my liver in-game?
What has Lucina been doing for a week?
You're better off selling your
no,
kidney mama. Because you have to.
Yeah.
Cleric things, blessing orcs, healing, and stuff like that.
Nobody's actually been taking on any smaller missions.
Nope.
How about Hakuchi? What have you been doing? What has Kirith Myrith been doing?
Taking down some scum.
Okay, you've been actually working. Yeah. Let's say you've been doing some bodyguard work then.
Yeah, pretty much bodyguard and what was it? Patrol.
Yeah. So in this case, since everyone else has been just lazing off, you're gonna lose a little bit of money.
No!
Yeah. I've already lost a lot of money, I'm not losing more!
You haven't been earning more and you've been doing living here for a week now. Of course it costs a little bit. If you would have been working a little bit, you could actually get money. So, on that one, Kirith has been actually doing work and he has earned himself 10 silver for this 1 week. It's not much, but it's something. The rest of you have actually lost 10 silver during the week.
How much?
Isn't 10 silver just 1 gold?
Yeah, pretty much.
How much did I lose?
10 silver.
Oh...
It's because of the lifestyle.
You
need to pay for your lifestyle.
Yeah, I need to oil my.
Your people have been spending a bit more money than you would have really needed because you've been lazing around. Ringo, for example, have been just recharging.
I have been lazing around.
I have to pay for oil and stuff to oil my gears and stuff. But 10 silver is 1 gold coin, right? So I have 49 now.
Yeah.
Okay. And 9 copper. Oh, no. No, I have 10 copper.
Yeah.
Because I remember Ornstein giving me back that copper.
I gave him the copper back.
Okay.
Wait, how many copper? You just gave me 1 copper, didn't you? So I've got to get rid of my copper.
Yes.
I thought I already did that, to be honest.
Oh, yeah, that's what I thought too. Maybe it doesn't save immediately. Or maybe it's like periodic save. I don't know. Anyways.
So yeah, last week on Dragon Ball Z, you were
really
trying to trade a dragon egg for fake diamonds, and you managed to fuck it up, but somehow managed to get the silver pin inside the trader's bags so that they could be traced, hopefully. And after that, Mickey O'Neill tried to rob Ringo for his 10 copper coins and managed to get his hands on Ringo's, what was it again, some kind of amulet or something, symbol. And other people saw that and they pretty much beat the heck out of Mickey, and he hopefully learned his lesson because he hasn't been just as bad as a thief after that. Most likely he's been just hiding his real skill and been doing things a bit more stealthy from now on.
No, I don't think so.
Who did that? I was busy. I got taken away. What did I miss? Why is everyone laughing? The fuck did I miss?
Just a small introduction, nothing too much.
Oh, for fuck's sake, man.
So yeah, this is what has been going on, and let us go on with the mission 2. This is more a little bit of repeat again, just for the memory. You were told that Madame Friona's tea kettle was the place where adventurers could find work and avoid the hassle associated with other places in Flan. So far, that has been true. Madame Friona, a stout and officious halfling who runs the establishment with her 5 daughters, has proven an excellent hostess. After a peaceful night's rest, Breeze, one of Madame Friona's 5 daughters, is serving you a delightful breakfast, which includes freshly made wildberry jam on warm biscuits. My sisters and I picked the berries ourselves, says the young halfling woman, sweeping her long black hair out of her face. Some say the wildberries in this area are... Before Breeze can finish her thought, a shriek erupts from the street outside the tea kettle.
What the fuck?
What the fuck? While the words are mostly unintelligible, you do make out words like help and family. That was
fucking Ringo.
That was actually me at the same time, so don't worry about it.
Why is Ringo red?
When you were saying shriek, I did the shriek with the robot voice.
It is. It both did the same. Even I did the shriek voice, so.
Oh my god.
That's okay, perfectly timing there. So yeah. Yes. You hear a shriek of help and family and unintelligible words from somewhere out in the streets.
Lucina runs out. Runs out.
For Sarah.
Okay, Lucina and Sarah run out. What do the others do?
I walk outside.
Fuck that, I'm staying here.
I'm not gonna run with my plate on. Fuck that shit, I'm gonna walk in style.
I'm gonna drink one ale.
I'm gonna stand out the window and check it out. So, like, you know, I can see everything pretty much.
Okay. So, in the streets, you can see a woman collapse in middle of the road, crying hysterically, clutching an infant boy in her arms. And she is pretty much just crying and sobbing and muttering weird words with no real meaning and stuff. Just completely in distress.
Muttering words?
Unintelligible words, and you can sometimes hear words like help me and my family and stuff like that.
I got red language.
That only works if the person is actually speaking something that is a language.
Oh, right.
Wow.
So this person is completely panicking in a collapse of sorrow and fear and stuff, so...
What's wrong?
I walk outside, also. To join the group.
I'm still fucking staying inside.
Just looking at the window and... Oh my. Oh, by the way, she's kinda hot.
Oh, shit. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. I made him gay.
Can I roll a medicine check or something to see what's wrong with her, injury-wise?
Not the kid?
Yeah, you can roll that if you want.
19?
Yeah. You can see that she has a few bruises, but she's mostly unhurt. But she's in the middle of a panic, and you think that it might be better to try and soothe her out a little bit so she can actually calm down and maybe talk what has happened.
I'm gonna go outside and join the group.
Let's see.
This is the part where you can actually start role-playing.
Yeah, well...
Well...
What's her name? What was her name? Pancho, what was your character's name again? Sarah was already asking what's wrong, so I'll let her do the talking for now.
Okay. Animal handling.
But I don't want to talk.
What the hell?
Someone who said what's wrong?
Calm down, boy. Here you go, pat.
Okay, so what's happening now?
I'm waiting for the moment to answer me.
Sarah asked her what's wrong.
Yeah. She's still muttering and crying. Yeah. She's just muttering and crying a lot.
Oh.
I'm going to give her a big hard slap across the face.
No.
Holy fuck.
Wow.
Sure, if you really want to.
Sarah pushes Mickey back.
Mickey O'Neill approaches the woman and completely trips on his feet and plunges head first into the ground. This makes the woman actually go completely silent and confusedly look around of what the heck is happening, because Mickey also yells a little shriek on the way. Kind of thing.
Fuck off. Shouldn't I be the one who makes the shriek?
I just lift Mickey up. And just I don't say anything, I just lift him up like that. Like, fuck it.
Okay. The woman has clearly calmed down for whatever reason. She's completely confused of what the heck is going on.
Wait,
it's the first time she's looking around and seeing where she is. Just blinking her eyes and, what is this?
Are you okay now?
She's still sniffing a bit, but yeah, I'm a bit fine now. The funny guy there just calmed me down a bit. Even the baby is laughing a little bit.
You just hear me sniff inside my helmet like...
Okay. So...
My name is Millivent Moss. I own a farm... I own a farm of peat, a peat farm from a bog about an hour from here. Earlier this morning, my husband and my children and a few hard hands were attacked by goblins. I was able to leap onto a wagon and escape with my youngest child, Bo, still a baby. I drove away quickly, turning around just long enough to see the goblins tracking people away to the east. It looks like they were still alive, perhaps being taken captive. Oh, please, someone help us.
Are you the only one alive?
I don't know.
How much money are you going to pay me?
I smash Mickey to the floor.
Let us do it together. I'm helping you. By the way, if you try to use something like smash someone on the floor, you use athletics instead of strength save.
Athletics. Also, it's a reroll. That's a one roll.
Also, Akuchi, save is for protection and trying to dodge stuff. If you want to do something, you need to use the actual strength or acrobatics or athletics.
How do you select the things without the save then?
Click on the name. See along the side where you got strength one whatever. Just click on it.
Click the name.
I'll click on the name.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I give you help, so you'll get advantage on it.
Yeah.
Okay, so what is it? Do you want me to do athletics?
Athletics,
if you have proficiency.
Yeah, I just want to smack him to the face.
Yeah, athletics. Yeah,
yeah. There we go.
14. 14, that's fuck all, man.
You need to throw some dodging so you can decide if you go for athletics or acrobatics save.
Okay.
What, me?
Yeah, you.
Yeah, you.
You.
So what, is it a dex saving throw?
Yeah.
Acrobatics or athletics.
Yeah, okay. Acrobatics or athletics, because this isn't actual. Well then, suddenly you can, after you've done saying that, how much are you going to pay, you see a fist coming at you, and
hang
it hits
second,
you.
Wait, hold it, that roll doesn't count because you did it as a Kuji and not Killith. Reroll.
Oh shit.
No. It's
re-roll, he wasn't in character.
With the help of Hakuchi, Sarah, and Hakuchi. Sarah and Kirith both immediately you can see two fists coming towards you and they both punch you in the face and you find yourself lying down in the ground.
This is fucking gay.
Hold on, guys. Say to this man.
Ignore that. It's meant to be a sword. It's not a health potion bottle. It's a sword.
So how far is your farm?
It's about an hour away from Flam.
I'm not sure.
And she said that the people were being carried off, captured. Taken towards the east from the farm.
I'm not sure what these riffraff want, but I'm gonna go. So I just drop Mickey, like fuck it, and I start walking towards the farm. Fuck you guys.
Such a knob.
Sarah is just making the expression of using her hands like, I'm watching you. To Mickey.
Millivent says that I will pay anything I can if you just saved by family and friends.
Damn,
please help me. Help us.
I don't hear that. I'm already walking. I'm out.
yo, we gotta know how many goblins are. I mean,
no,
we don't.
Just come on. Let's go.
See, has no idea.
Okay.
So yeah, you just start walking.
You're just coming with us without.
Well, okay, she did mention a lot of a pay, so maybe Mickey gets interested.
I mean Ringo.
What?
You're just coming without saying anything back.
Yeah, I'll just tag along.
Yep. Shrug.
Yeah, shrug. I just walk.
The moment you start walking, two Blackfist guards come up in the scene and order people to stop blocking the traffic on the street. And Millivent tells her story to them as well, and they just roll their eyes and say, that's not our jurisdiction area, we only work during the city itself. And then one of them pulls a small piece of paper from the pouch and hands it to the nearest adventurer, and pretty much says, you, go and investigate this thing. He actually pushes the paper into Sarah's hands.
Aww.
What?
The what?
The paper is a promissory note entitling its bearer to 50 gold pieces from the city's coffers for services rendered.
Oh, shit.
So now you actually will have a reward if you manage to do this investigation.
Oh, shit. Snap. Let's go.
That's all you need. Millivent actually comes with you to show the road to back to her place and gives you a ride on her wagon back to the farm.
Oh, nice.
And she also shows you once more during the way. She shows you where the raid took place and tells you once more that it looked like the goblins were taking the prisoners to the east. She doesn't know the number of the goblins, but she also claims that there were too many to count.
Fucking
looks like we got some work to do.
So yeah, for
let's
now
fight some goblins.
The thing is that you still don't know which direction exactly to go, so you would need to check for footprints or something to find your way.
Oh, I'm already
this is
around.
A swamp land, so oh, of fuck. Course tracks are kind of easy to find.
I'm going to check for footprints.
Yes, that and that happen. Would be a wisdom survival check for everyone trying what? To do it. One character may oh, attempt this one, and everyone else can assist using the help action, and that will give you advantage on the troll. So the one trying must have been Ringo because of the 20.
Everybody's like, let's help him!
Yes, help me.
I don't know how, what do I do?
Survival, lowest thing in the skill part.
You don't have to troll it. If you're helping, then you don't troll it.
Actually. I can't no. survive!
The people are so bad at surviving, oh come on.
We don't really have to help Ringo.
Without Ringo, you would be dead by nighttime, I guess.
Why wouldn't?
Why would I be dead by nighttime?
Not dead, but...
You I'd couldn't probably. Find lost. Anywhere, you would get lost within the first 5 meters. Okay, anyways. You easily find the tracks of the goblins. And you find certain information about them. The trails make it appear that about a dozen prisoners were being tracked. Also, the prints in the mud show that more than a dozen goblin-sized creatures passed through here today. And one larger-sized creature also walked with the other creatures. Because the print size of the footprint is probably larger than a human. But not as large as an ogre, so it's not that big.
Okay, okay. Well, I'd say let's go. Do we have a torch? Do we need a torch?
Is it not yet.
Oh.
Okay.
What time is it? That's actually a good question.
Yeah.
Right now it's kind of just daytime. And
midday.
It's about midday, yeah. Let's say it like
okay.
that.
Excellent.
And you go into the swamp following these footprints. It takes you about 1 hour until you finally follow the trail to an entrance, mouth of a cave, on the side of a hill rising from the bog. And bow.
Oh,
welcome
shit.
To your first map.
It's totally black. It's yeah, a nighttime. Yeah.
Time. Holy yeah. shit. Fucking worst map ever.
So you can't actually see the lights that I've put down. Why
can't I
you
see?
Nope. Just blackness.
That should not be possible. I put torches here. Why don't they work?
Are the characters actually there?
Yeah, the characters are in here.
Yeah.
I put torches around here that are supposed to give light that everyone can see.
I can't see! Oh, there it is! I found my character.
Please don't write in the map. Your characters are supposed to be... Did that work?
I saw something, yeah.
Yeah.
We saw your ping, but we don't see our characters.
Yeah. Yeah, I see your ping.
So that's what I'm trying to
fix. Are we in a cave right now?
No, you're outside it for now. Okay.
Firebolt!
Oh no, wait.
Now do you see something, Ringo?
Yes, I do. Oh my god, dude. Oh, that's so cool, dude.
Okay, so wait, I need to put this setting for everyone. And I need to remember to do this every time we switch a map because these settings have not been saved for anything.
Ah, oh, shit, I can see.
I have eyes!
I don't! There we go, I have eyes now.
One last character. There you go.
Well,
you can actually see stuff now. So yeah, I put the torches outside because it's daytime outside, but the cave starts here, so don't worry about it too much.
By the way, is this one of those maps that your friend made?
Yes, this is one of the maps that my friend Shami has made for us.
Oh, nice. Everyone is
so,
just
yeah.
jumping around. Whee!
But now I'm gonna tell you the rules on how to work with maps.
Okay.
Basically, you do not move big jumps at a time. You only move a little bit, wait until other people move around a little bit as well. And that way, it's like spending a few seconds at a time to move around. And when you go to a certain place, if I say stop, you everyone will stop moving their characters because something will happen at that point.
Okay.
Also, as always, when you go to a certain area, if you want to check for traps or secrets or anything, you need to mention it. Unless you don't, you will be just going in blindly and just tricking everything possible and missing everything interesting.
Okay.
Let's do that.
And also, I need to get a certain number from you people.
17.
I need to know what your passive perception is.
Okay, passive perception. Let's start with Ringo. Yeah.
Could you this time, can you put the roll 20s on squares? Does it work with this map?
No.
Passive perception as well.
Passive perception should be at the bottom.
Oh, yeah. Right below
passive
the scale.
Passive wisdom in brackets.
Passive wisdom,
perception.
11.
Yep.
Hold on.
What is it? Ringo is 11.
11.
Okay.
Hold on. 13.
That's not a lot, is it?
13.
So, okay. Sarah is 13.
How does that barbarian have more than me?
15.
I'm a wizard, Sina. Bitch.
Sina, 15. Okay, how about Mickey and Killis?
Never mind what mine is. I'm ashamed.
No, it's worse.
It's like minus 6.
It's fucking 9.
Ouch.
Good rogue, good rogue.
The one
at 11.
How about
Kilith? Kilith
is on 11.
11.
Why is mine so fucking low?
Because you have a negative of wisdom.
Well, I didn't realize wisdom was important.
Well, you gotta
all
use it.
All the stats are important.
Yeah.
In a way. In their own unique ways.
Yes. I now have the list of your perception numbers. And I will be making use of this.
Yes. Oh, great. We're going to get wrecked.
Okay.
Okay. So, pretty much, this is where you can start moving around slowly. But
okay.
Before you move too much, I will be reading a text here.
Okay. But can I look around first, see what's, like, at the entrance? Is there, like, anything special?
There's
not
nothing.
Looked.
Yeah, there's not a lot there. But don't go inside yet. You are still not this close to the entrance, so you're still
okay.
A bit further away.
That's what she said.
Out here.
So yeah.
Killit, you're on your own!
At the entrance, the characters observe a goblin talking in common to a human-sized figure dressed in heavy cloaks that obscure his face. The voice is male and human-sounding. The goblin says in broken common, "Only one trading group return. They bring prisoners. Other trading groups return soon. No more snake coin people found." The human nods and says, "Excellent. Tell Gurung that my friends and I will pay lots of coin and give lots of gifts for all the dragon artifacts you can find. And kill any other human you find near your home." The goblin nods and enters the cave while the cloaked figure whispers to a word and simply vanishes away.
What did he whisper?
He whispers a word, so you can't really hear it, you're kind of far away. Basically, it's a magic word that makes him teleport away or something.
Oh shit.
Yeah, he disappeared right in front of my eyes, fucking scumbag.
But that didn't work.
Oh, I will. I will find you.
So yeah.
Okay.
Pretty
can
much. You can see that the cave is completely dark, and as a common knowledge, goblins can see in the dark, so they do not need any light at all. So if this is a goblin lair, there will be no torches most likely, and you are gonna have to have your own sources of light, or you're not gonna be seeing anything in there.
I have 3 torches, but I can also cast. Wait. Can I not cast like minor illusion or something and create like a little light?
No.
No.
Can't. Oh yeah, the image cannot create sound, light, smell, or any sensory effect.
RIP!
Sarah puts her torch up then. Okay. Let me give you your torchlight.
Nice.
Do I have a torch?
I have one too.
Oh, I do.
Do we want multiple torches or do we want one? I think it's good to have.
It's good to have multiple. At least two, yeah.
And Mickey has the lantern, so I will be putting.
Well, it we have to. We have to then.
Lucina gonna.
I have three more.
What's Lucina gonna do?
Gonna cast light to her. Yeah.
To... Oh shit.
To where?
Touch one object that is no larger than 10 feet in any dimension.
So
what are you touching?
Sealed.
Touch Mickey's dick.
it's like a fucking anime.
Okay, I'm gonna have to move Lucina to a different place to see the light levels. I have not counted anything other than the 60 feet thingy, so... So if I put 30 in here, how big is the light radius?
Except mine. My other character.
3, 4, 5, 6... Wait. It's that's 10, 20... Yeah, this is the area of your light, and then dim starts from there. So, there you go. You have been prepped.
Cool.
Beautiful.
Let's go.
Beautiful. Can I investigate for any signs of traps or anything at the entrance?
Yeah, you will just need to roll some perception there.
Perception or just investigation?
Perception, if you notice anything, that would be bad.
Let us see. Me too.
Oh shit. Ring of the high rolls.
Okay.
In before Mickey too. And...
yeah. You are checking around, and you hear a little bit of voice from the walls here. Oh, and you notice that there's actually some kind of holes there fit for arrows to go through. And you hear some soft guttural mumbling of two goblins just talking with each other. Apparently they're on guarding duty, but they're not doing a good job because they're not really looking through the holes there.
Oh.
But they will clearly hear you if you have to make too much noise.
Ooh. I think we just gotta
Mickey O'Neill hears nothing. But Killith and Ringo and Sarah, you three notice that hole there, and you can decide if you want to tell the others or not. Of course, it might be a good time to start whispering.
Tell me, dickhead. There's a hole in the wall.
Dude, I just want to go in loud.
Oh my god, what's that?
Fuck is it?
Someone just blew up on their microphone.
Yeah.
Who the fuck would do such a thing?
We should sneak past.
I think.
You think I can sneak? You're funny.
No, we have plate armor.
Since you have plate armor, it's gonna be a disadvantage if you try to do a stealth.
You guys go on ahead. I'll follow suit.
You're a bit fucking slow, so I'm gonna go right ahead and sneak through.
Yep, then roll for stealth.
Okay.
I mean... Mr. Tin Can!
There we go, that's a good roll.
Oh, shit.
So, do I get through?
Uh-huh.
That's a beautiful stealth. Aww. Too bad you don't witness anything with your perception.
Shut the fuck up.
You don't even see what you're stealthy from, but you're perfect at stealthing. Congratulations.
Yeah, no, Ringo fucking told me.
Yeah, but you still... You can see it now, but... You wouldn't have noticed it without the help of Ringo.
Lucina,
holy crap.
Sorry, it's disadvantage for me.
Oh, right.
Why have you got such shit stealth?
Mickey O'Neill is the perfect example of how to sneak around. You hear nothing even though he's right next to you and he's moving around. But the rest of you are just ringing like it's Christmas.
How far in do I get to go?
And the goblins clearly hear you because they become kind of confused and immediately start pointing their weapons through the holes there and arrows start flying towards you.
Should we go in?
We are gonna be getting into our first combat here.
Oh, check.
Because we were all fucking around.
So, start rolling for initiative.
Click your token first and then roll the initiative.
Don't worry, these are goblins. They're stupid.
I
like this.
I don't remember how to roll initiative.
What's up with the fucking 7 today? Well, the last roll is 772.
How do I roll it again? I forgot.
Just
initiative. The three buttons next to your inspiration. Like, if you see your strength to the right, it's inspiration to the right, armor class to the right, initiative. You click the name. Initiative.
Okay. Yay.
Why am I
am the fastest.
That yay was so inspirational.
There we go. And this is the battle order.
Oh, snap.
So yeah, pretty much in the arrow slits there, the goblins just get a bit closer. That's just for you to actually see that they're at the arrow slits there.
Goblin! Goblin!
I see goblins.
Goblin.
Yeah.
So did they shoot through the windows already?
They are planning to shoot. You realize that you've been noticed, and this is not a surprise round.
So we noticed them.
That they noticed you because you were being so loud.
Do I get noticed? Even though
Mickey O'Neill's ears. It sounds like everyone else is screaming with their gloves, and he's like, "Oh my god, this team is so bad at this thing."
And to be fair, you are like the worst team.
What do you expect?
Yeah, but the problem is that Mickey is in the front because you said that you're gonna go straight in. And since they look through the holes, you're the first thing they see because you are right there in middle of their
room. Yeah, but I'm literally invisible.
This is not some Skyrim people view. Watching.
This is Skyrim, yeah. That's the best one.
Just remember that if you try to sneak, like, okay, where is Mickey going?
Yeah. Right up the wall there, I guess.
Yeah, because I have my torch up, and if he did sneak through me, next to me...
It doesn't matter, they have dark vision.
Yeah, true.
So, basically, the passage is unlit, and although the sunlight reaches far enough into the 10-foot wide cave passage to let you see that it travels about 25 feet before turning south. Piles of rubble are strewn in the passage, large enough to hide behind, pretty much. And here, yes, we see your ruler. But it's not gonna work because the numbers gives you is wrong. One square is 5 feet. That's all you need to know. One square is 2.9, but it's 5 feet. Just let it be 5 feet. You can just count squares. I'm not that stingy about that.
Okay.
One square is 2.8 feet.
No, it's 5 feet.
Okay, so anyways.
So now that we're on fight, you cannot move unless it's your turn. Every turn takes 6 seconds. So whenever you do things, they happen within 6 seconds. When everyone stands there moves, they basically do it at about the same time or something like that. The one that has their turn first acts a little bit faster than the other one, so if you manage to kill a goblin before his turn comes, he cannot shoot because he's dead at that time. And that's basically how we'll be working.
Please make it so I'm about to wet myself.
Yeah.
Turn-based combat.
Yes. Sarah, you can start. Oh, another thing. There can only be one person for each of these squares, so you cannot stop inside another person's square. That's one of the things that makes it easier if you just go by the square rules. Yeah,
I know. I think that's good.
You can still pass through your friends. That's only difficult terrain, and that means that you will need double the movement speed if you go through a friend.
Okay. So, yeah.
It's but like you can also decide to go like sideways like this, and that's still only 5 feet because you're going through one square.
So how many feet can you walk in one turn?
Well, if your movement speed is 30, then you can actually move through
Six blocks.
Yeah. All right.
So what can we do each move? What can we do each turn?
Each turn, so you can use one action to attack or do stuff. You can use a bonus action, and you can move. You can do all of these in one turn.
You can use your whole attack in one turn.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
And you can use your bonus action if you have one.
And don't forget that you can continue moving after shooting if you still have movement left. But the other thing you need to remember is that if you go to a melee of an enemy and then try to leave, the enemy will get an attack of opportunity against you when you try to leave his range of attack.
Yes.
Yeah. Just keep in mind that there's only one reaction per round, so if there's like two characters next to one and they both leave his square, he can only hit one character.
Yeah. Also, you can just decide to react on the enemy's turn. That will stop you immediately and you ready your weapon or something like that. If the goblin pokes his head through the arrow slit, I will shoot him. That's one possibility. So the moment the goblin comes up to try and shoot you, you will shoot him first because you've done your react onto that one. But that also stops you from... Yeah, it has to be your turn first.
Right.
Yeah, and if you use that ready action, you can only ready one action or movement.
Yeah.
Okay. So you can't have both on one ready. And then there's the help action, which means you like try to distract a target or something and give advantage to anyone else attacking the enemy.
Fuck that.
Mickey has the special thing that if you have a friend next to the enemy you're attacking, you actually get a free sneak attack whenever you hit it, so...
Yep.
Hmm.
Other characters have different things, and don't forget that Lucina can buff you, so you have even better chance of doing stuff on the fights.
Also, the sneak attack does trigger multiple times per turn, round, if possible.
Seriously, I am actually about to wet myself. Can we please do this?
Okay, Sarah, you can start. Go ahead,
I can start. One more thing about the...
No one more thing!
The iPhone 6S.
Obstacles. Oh. Like, if there's another character in between you two.
Yeah,
it's like, it gives plus 2 AC to armor class to the enemy you are targeting. And if it misses, but hits the target in between you, it will hit that one. So be careful when you shoot through your friends.
And one more thing. The arrow slit behind is actually 3/4 protection, so they get an extra 5 armor class just by being behind that. And since they are right next to the hole, you don't get the same protection from that hole.
Yeah. Do it long. Okay, we can.
Okay. Now, if you forget any of this, we will just remind you of it time, so don't worry about
it. Yeah, we will complain about
it. Yeah. If you try to shoot in the hole, I will tell you how hard it is gonna be, and you can decide to not shoot after all if you want to.
I don't mind blasting Mickey O'Neil.
Okay, so go ahead now. Finally move, damn it.
Okay, yeah.
Clink, clank, clank. Oops.
Well then, since this is a corner, I want to instead use my search action to check if there is anything like on the right side.
On there in the room, you don't really see any enemies at least. You just see another room. The room is littered with ratty blankets and bedrolls, some small bones from eaten rodents and other filthy remnants of fine goblin living. Lice-ridden furs decorate the walls.
Okay, so there's no enemies there, so I don't have to use my search action. So I'll be just going right here and poke the fucking torch into the arrow slit.
That wall is 5 feet thick there, so you can just barely... Aww. Fit through that if you try.
Well, I can always scare them.
So you poke your torch through there.
Yeah.
Okay, try to hit it. They still have the protection from being behind the thing, so because it's so far away from your melee weapon.
Okay. I don't care.
So try hitting them.
Okay, I'll try hitting him.
What would it be for a toss? Does it actually have any stats?
It's a. You can. It can be the. What are the weapons that don't belong to weapons actually?
Improvised weapons.
Improvised weapons. Yeah. You can rule it as a attack with a club, because it's like a club.
But basically, if you're trying to attack with a club, you are sticking it into their heads with fire. So basically, that weapon would work. In my opinion, it would be like your strength bonus plus 1d4 from the fire. This kind of attack, because you are trying to poke it through a big long hole.
But what about my attack roll?
You need to do it like a club roll, I guess.
Club roll. Okay, well then, it's a proficiency for me then. Let's move that. And plus 2. What?!
You poke your torch into the hole, and your hold from the weapon actually slips. The torch falls into the other side and just turns off. And thanks to that, bye bye light.
No.
I just need to hold my shield up then. I'm gonna hold my shield in front of the arrow slip.
Oh god, they can shoot through that then. Well then, that's all you're gonna do?
Well, I can't do anything else.
Goblin number one will try to shoot the closest one he can see, and that's Mickey O'Neill.
What the fuck, man? What about this dickhead here who just chucked his torch away?
Well, he is blocking the other hole and he can't even reach or shoot that way.
Yeah, he can't see from the arrow slit there properly.
But this one can shoot from here.
Okay then, so-called dungeon master.
Here we go. This is what I'm talking about. The goblins always kill themselves in my games for some reason. The goblin short bow, literally you hear a crack and it turns into half. It just goes into pieces basically in his hands. And it also hits the goblin into his face. And it deals 1d4 damage to the goblin.
Well,
that's not too much.
The goblin can't fucking do anything right.
And the goblin takes a few steps back behind the arrow slit because he no longer has a weapon, so he cannot be shot from there anymore. He's really angry, but
he's
doesn't do more than that.
Oh, that's amazing. We got a short-tempered goblin.
Well then, that was all the badges of this session.
Mickey!
Yeah. Fuck you, man. I'm going to move forward a little bit, I suppose, so I can see shit.
Is your sword not long enough to poke through the hole?
No, it's a fucking short sword.
That's what she said.
I am.
Not a lot.
So I'm going to start fucking... I'm going to walk around the corner, because I can move like 6, so...
Yeah, go. Move your character.
Don't know how.
Stop the ruler. You have to click the mouse button. Like on the top left.
This is... There you go, that's 6. Okay. And, what?
Is that 6? Wait, that's 5.
No, that's 6. There we go, that's 6.
That's 5. That's 5, actually.
That's 5.
But this is 6.
Yeah. That's 6. And the moment you reach that part...
Drop!
There is a tripwire that you just triggered. Congratulations.
Oh!
And... there's a tripwire. It was set across the entrance to this room, roughly 2 feet above the ground. And you set it off, and stones start falling into the ceiling, from the ceiling, into the 10 foot by 40 foot section in this first area, the hallway pretty much.
What?
The what? One where Sarah is standing and Mickey.
Oh my fucking god!
And, you twat.
Best rogue ever, guys. Best rogue.
Oh gosh.
Any creature in this area takes a 2d4 bludgeoning damage from the falling rocks. A so successful dexterity saving throw of difficulty 10 halves this damage. So throw dexterity saving throw, both of you.
Oh, fucking.
Oh, shit. There goes Sarah.
Mickey, you try as well.
How much damage?
I will be throwing the damage soon. Don't worry about it. I'll do a separate roll for both of you.
Mickey just needs to do the dexterity save.
Yeah.
He just laughs. He laughs at the fucking
I like roll. How he laughs and then in before he rolls a one.
Oh my
so
god.
So what, I gotta do a dex save?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Because you're getting out of the rocks as well.
Oh.
Yep, he's not dodging bad. Half of the rocks.
Well, yeah, he has though. Plus five.
So yeah, this is 2d4.
It would've gone A2.
This damage is for Shara. A full damage for you.
What?
Holy crap.
And Mickey takes half of the next roll that I'm doing. 2 damage.
It's critical one.
Wow. The bastard.
I lost almost half of my health.
Okay.
Yeah.
Also, alarms are ringing off everywhere in the lair now. Something like that. They have a complicated set of wires going everywhere with just random things clinging and clanging. Sarah got tiggered. Yes, you did.
Triggered.
Also, almost team killed.
So yeah, that's as far as they can move.
I still have an attack on this turn. I'm going to shoot Sarah with my bow.
No.
Really?
Okay, I won't.
Fucking hell.
Don't make yourself KO in the very
first. You can't even draw your bow because you
just so
you have your sword in hand.
Yeah, but also just so you realize, most of our characters will leave you for dead here.
Bitch, please, I'll fucking leg it. You can't catch me.
Yo, can we not just build?
Can we at just this level, only two attacks are enough to actually kill you.
Fuck you all!
If you really feel like it.
So yeah, Lucina, your turn.
1, 2, 3, 4.
There are a few rocks over there in the ground. Pretty much, if you say that you're hiding behind a rock, you will get a half quarter of protection from the enemies trying to shoot.
Well, I don't see any hoplings there. I can off wait here and gonna do ready action. I'm gonna cast Sacred Flame when I see enemy.
Okay.
Or the left hole. Or upper one.
Upper one.
Yeah. Okay, you're gonna ready there. So
yeah.
Kill it.
I saw what Sarah did, and I realized that's a smart-ass idea. So my character's gonna do the same with the other hole. And basically slam his shield up against the hole.
Oh, I thought you were gonna...
I'm rushing in!
I'm gonna drop my torch too!
No, I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna slam my shield. Up yours, bitches!
You're gonna slam it in there. Okay.
In the meantime...
We're good, let's go.
Do you use any action or anything?
No, I'm not going to do anything. I just ready up my shield and slam it completely shut.
The goblin looking at Sarah's shield there is just making annoyed noises and readying his bow, ready to shoot the moment Sarah moves an inch.
Snap.
Also, I need to read up on a thing here quickly. Okay, nothing too important there. So I'm gonna have to ready the rooms that you will be arriving soon. There we go. And the Ringo.
I take one, two, three. Wait, if I go through someone, is it the same amount?
If you go through someone, it's the double amount of movement for that slot.
So 4, 5, 6. Right? Right?
That's 1, 2, 3, 4. You can still go under. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can still move one slot if you want. One square.
Don't wanna. I'm just gonna ready, cast my, ready action my.
You know, if you're there, you're right in front of Lucina, so she could get.
Yeah,
problems.
But I'm checking the bottom line. Like, I mean, it could be a goblin jumping out, or maybe Mickey. So I can, you know.
Fuck off, man.
Icky Mickey.
You're already.
So yeah, ready, cast my fireball or flame. Bolt? Firebolt?
Firebolt.
It's called Firebolt, yes.
Yeah.
Stop breaking character, Panjo.
In a way, it's kind of sad if you have to tell your wizard what spell it is.
Don't worry about it. That's how we all start in this game.
Yeah.
Man, wizard is kind of a artist of the glasses, yeah. In my opinion.
Yeah.
No, rogue, man. Rogue.
So, Sarah.
Rage!
And?
And?
What are you gonna do?
Dutch.
You just move out of the way.
Sarah got knocked out by the 1,000,000
points. I use my action to activate the dodge. And then... opens the window.
Yeah. Immediately when you move the shield, there's an arrow coming through to your face, and you're using your dodge to avoid it.
Yeah.
Oh, shit, it's gonna hit me though.
Also, if you dodge it, the next one it could hit is Ringo or Lucina. So.
Too bad. Oh! Holy shit!
Oh.
Well then. That's that. I think it hits.
It's a disadvantage, so it doesn't hit me.
Oh shit, dude.
Only against you is a disadvantage then.
Yeah.
So yeah. But the arrow keeps on going and it immediately hits Ringo.
Can I cast shield?
If you have a reaction for it.
What's my reaction?
Can you use it as a reaction?
Can I use it as a reaction?
Mm-hmm. It reads in the spell description if you can use it as a reaction.
It casts time one reaction.
Okay, well then.
But is it should I do it?
Yeah, if you do that, you use up your ready action. Like you can't use your ready.
Yeah, I can't use my fireball anymore. Fireball.
Yeah.
But
fireball
so
level
I use this
one.
If you use your the shield, I think it's gonna still hit you anyways. Unless doesn't it have to be a different attack roll?
It goes with the same one because it's already shot.
Okay.
Jesus Christ!
you cannot defend against that.
Can I just try to dodge?
No.
You're surprised because Seraph moves away and dodges an arrow and she doesn't realize that you're right behind her, so it goes right into your
face.
All right, get back here.
Something like that. And here comes the damage.
Damn it.
Holy shit!
I'm
Ringo goes down! The zero health.
Wow. He's fucking shitty, dude.
Remember to put your health down to zero.
Yeah.
And if nobody helps you, you're gonna be fighting for your life next, so.
No glory, no worry.
Don't worry, there's Lucina right behind you.
Yeah, true.
Yeah. Sorry, there's some goblin murmurs and stuff from the other side of the wall there, He's snickering, laughing there.
I'm still moving, so.
Oh yeah, I still see your turn.
1, 2, 3.
Watch out, there's a trap there.
You used it already.
Do you guys see like icons that I put on?
Yeah, those are okay, for
this is my icon. Look at my icon.
You got arrowed in the back, not in the knee.
Oh my god, dude.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
That is close.
I'm gonna take a risk because she is raging, so...
Just investigate, you fucking dick.
I can't!
You're gonna kill me!
Says the guy that almost killed her.
Shut the fuck up, man. I'm gonna die, Sarah.
That's my maximum.
Fucking die.
That's my maximum. That's my maximum, yeah. So... That's about
gonna, you're not gonna open the door yet?
I don't have anything to use. I pretty much use my user object as to remove my shield from the wall.
Okay. In that case, yeah, the goblin sneakers in there and Mickey.
Well, I'm going to follow that path that Sarah took because I know it isn't trapped. See? Using my head.
Or you can use your search action.
Shut up, man. I'm going to stay here. And I'm gonna make sure this door ain't trapped, so I don't wanna die.
1, 2, 3. That's 4 slots. You still have 2 slots to move if you want.
I wanna make sure the door isn't fucking trapped before I go through it.
Okay, you search the drawer. Roll for inspection.
Investigation.
Yeah, investigation. And just give me a moment. Where the heck is this door?
Oh my.
Yeah, it's not a door actually.
That's it's not
the,
a door?
No. That's the wolf pelts hanging in there, actually.
Okay.
And you don't really see anything there. You should have rolled... Actually, roll perception. You're trying to find if there's anything special there in the corner. So roll perception instead.
Perception,
though. Oh, yeah. Don't worry. You actually notice that, hey, there's actually a hidden door behind this wolf pelts hanging in there.
Shit, man.
Removing the pelts, you manage to reveal the door.
Can I go through the door?
You can open the door if you want.
I'm gonna open the door.
Okay.
Is it open or unlocked?
It's unlocked. It swings okay. Open.
Nice. Boop!
Ah, there's a goblin!
Ah, goblins!
A goblin?
Goblin.
And in addition, I'm gonna have to add some more people into this fight.
Kill me, please.
What was it that Gary always said?
Holy shit!
How many fucking goblins are there?
Whoops! Healing. Wait, those last two weren't actually goblins, sorry.
Oh, for fuck's sake!
those last two
are they? Are they shambles or some shit?
Where is this?
So you just open the fucking door and there's like 5 people jumping out?
Never mind the fucking door, open Pandora's fucking box!
What the fuck do you think when we're going into an enemy's nest? Jesus Christ, use your brain!
Of course it doesn't come, man. There you go. You fucking doing anything.
So the last 2 goblins don't count.
They're right? Actually wolves.
3 goblins and 2 wolves.
Yeah. And I haven't named these wolves, so let me do that now.
Steven and
Wolfie and Susan.
And that's
that's fucking such boring names, man.
It's like Thomas.
But Thomas is a fucking great name.
It's gay.
At least people can pronounce my name.
No, they're not surprised. They were waiting for you because of the alarm.
Check.
They're already, but they don't get a surprise round either. So.
Do I still get to attack this turn?
You used your action on investigating.
Yeah.
Oh, that's gay.
And let me just get this order sorted. So there we go. And you still have your 10 feet if you want to move anywhere. Like, out of the way from the arrows that will most likely be coming soon.
So bang, bang.
Before a surprise attack times 5.
Wait, no.
And, Lucina.
Please.
Heal me, please.
Your ready action didn't work because you were pretty much concentrating on the upper hole, so you didn't notice the goblin in the bottom one.
One, two, gonna move here.
Oh shit, are you gonna block? Oh shit.
Of course I'm gonna block. And I use my bonus action to heal Ringo.
Okay.
So
give us the spell.
So, healing word.
Oh, that's nice.
You can just... There we go.
Oh shit, 4
Ringo
HP.
Gets 4 HP and you get back on your feet. Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning, sunshine.
You become conscious and you feel a little bit better now and you're back in action.
Ohayou gozaimasu.
Welcome, friend.
Also, it takes half of your movement to actually get back up on your feet. So, you're prone in the ground, you're lying in the ground. If you want to get up on your turn, you will need to use half of your movement to do that.
Oh, shit.
So that's like 15.
Yeah, that's 15.
Then I gonna cast Sacred Flame that goblin boost of Ringo.
Yes.
Okay. Do it.
I just realized
he's close, he doesn't get anything. He doesn't get any protection because you're so close to the hole and you can aim with your vision.
And, well, the Sacred Flame ignores protection.
I can Texas that.
Ooh.
Jeez. So. Two damage. Oh well.
And dexterity saving throw there.
Yeah.
What is the
saving throw? Damage. Code? Still.
What is the saving?
No. Rip? Nothing. Sorry.
I think up until now, your Sacred Flame hasn't done any damage.
Nope.
It just looks pretty. That's all it does.
Yeah.
It's a bright flaming light that hits the goblin into the face by 2 damage, and he is clearly taken aback, baffled, and
Wait.
Hurt.
It's not hit.
It doesn't hit because the dexterity save of 13.
Oh, yeah. It did hit.
And
oh,
you
never
rolled
mind.
16.
Never mind.
And it doesn't take any. It doesn't have the damage. It is ignored.
Yeah.
Well. Yeah, it's just so bright lights to the goblin. He is baffled. Oh, pretty lights. Stupid human has pretty lights.
Yeah. And I gonna be here.
You're gonna plug it with your shield.
Yeah.
Okay. Yay, we're butt plugs. I mean, shield plugs.
So, Sarah, you cannot see anything. There's an arrow to your face.
Holy shit. Well, throw.
Why haven't you relit your torch?
Well, he kind of threw it to the goblins on the other side of the wall.
Do you not have multiple torches?
He would need to use an action to actually light one up.
But I'm raging! 16. It actually does hit. And it's half the damage.
Half?
Half. I have resistance while raging.
Oh yeah, so is it down or up when it's evened?
No, he has disadvantage, right? Because rage.
Yeah.
No, but No. Wait, the damage goes half, so is it evened up or down?
Down.
So then you get 1 damage.
Are you listening to Ornstein right now?
Let's see.
It reads on the spell itself. Skill itself. Rounded up or down.
Oh, yeah. Round
it. Oh, it's deciding whether you die or not. How much health do you have left?
Isn't Seraph one of the most healthiest ones in the team?
So is it the round down or up?
That's what I want to know.
Usually it's round down.
You always round down unless told otherwise.
Okay, so it's round down then.
Nice. Just one damage.
Yeah. But you have an arrow in your knee.
I don't care!
You're racing, it doesn't stop your adventuring.
Indeed.
Kill it! You also, Sarah, hears the wolf barks in there. Wow, wow! Oh yeah, kill it! You're still blocking a hole.
Yeah, I just yell to the back, keep moving. And that's it, that's all I do. Okay.
Yes.
Goblin 2 is really angry, readies his bow, he's ready to shoot the moment the hole is open again.
This is a good
tactic. Just change holes.
You hear more barking.
More barking?
Yeah. And Ringo.
Oh, I try to move, like, wait, is if I move a diagonal line, is that also one square?
Yeah.
Okay, two. Three. Wait, what's that shit on the... What's the blue thing on the side?
That's most likely a place where the goblins have been littering and eating and sleeping and stuff.
Oh.
Goblin shit, man.
Yeah.
I don't... Okay.
We have limited assets on making these maps, so...
What is this?
That looks like a piece of rock with a stick on next to it, so...
Piece of plastic?
No, there's no such thing as plastic in this ball, so... It's just a useless crap or something.
Okay.
It could be poop, for all I care.
Yeah, okay, I'm just gonna stay put.
I'm gonna stay there. Okay. And, Sarah.
We are going in!
You do not see anything.
I can't see anything there.
I literally do not see anything.
It's dark.
Yeah, that means you can't go in there either.
Yo, can you not put up another torch?
He's racing. She's not really thinking too straight, I guess.
Oh. Yeah.
She says, come on, give me some light or else. Just pacing around.
I suppose I could do that.
Or you could
I'm gonna throw a javelin.
Just oh shit.
Randomly throwing it. Exactly what direction you're shooting it at?
Pretty much straightforward.
Okay. Well, throw it. It will be a disadvantage throw, even if it could hit or not.
Let's see. Javelin. Disadvantage. There we go. And it reaches 30 feet.
Oh shit.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, but with that... you hear angry voices from the front, but then you just hear a clang as your javelin reaches the ground. Let me see. Yeah, it just reaches the ground, pretty much. Okay.
Come out!
Now I need to make sure that I remember this correctly. Okay. You hear a cage being opened. Scring!
What?
Scring!
Yeah, I can hear a metallic cage being opened.
Scring!
And
that's about it.
Boom, boom, boom.
Oh, okay.
And this one keeps snickering there annoyedly. He has no bow, so it's not really doing much. And then you hear another cage being opened.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
You could just imagine the wolves being free right now. And Mickey!
Yeah, I'm really undecided what to do.
I'm
undecided to take the opportunity of Sarah being blind and robbing her, or giving her a source of light.
That's fucking hilarious.
I can still see in this room, just so you know.
Yeah, because you have
to. Fuck it then, you're not having it. I am going to take the opportunity to pickpocket Sarah. I think I should get advantage because she's blind.
She's not blind.
No, she's fucking blind.
No. I'm not blind. I just can't see in the room.
Because she doesn't have a light source of her own. She can see perfectly fine with you because you have a light source.
I'm gonna try and pickpocket her.
Okay, that's your action for the turn.
Scumbag.
I think it does go against your perception, so...
Ow.
Congratulations! Wow. Let me see what you pickpocket.
Wait.
You managed to pickpocket yourself, are there any actual rules on how much he can pickpocket in one go?
Depends on the DM as well as how much sleight of hand he does and dexterity and everything, I think.
Okay, so in that case, I'm gonna make the number a random between 1 and the difference between the sleight of hand and the perception. So that would be 1d6.
Mm-hmm.
This many gold coins you managed to steal.
Yay!
Rip.
Aww.
Aww.
It's not a bad amount, though.
Definitely not, no.
It's all you could take without her noticing you doing it. Also, Ringo is there, so you could also roll for perception if you want.
Oh yeah.
But since you're not expecting it to happen...
My robot senses tingling.
Okay, wait.
Oh yeah, perception? You are watching! You are watching!
Perception, right?
Yeah, perception.
Yeah,
you're not seeing anything. You're not seeing anything. You're just thinking that Mickey might be thinking of giving light to Sarah or something.
My character's fucking slow, holy fuck, dude.
Oh, I have to give light to Sarah, or I'll have to take another action, so I can't do it.
Or... He could be perverting!
He could be moving behind Sarah so she could see the goblins and go attack them, so you could enjoy the show from behind.
Fine, I'll be such a nice guy and I'll do that. You better block the fucking arrows.
Hiding behind a little girl. And you can see that the wolf too there is, the cage door is open and he's about to charge out.
Yeah.
Lucina. Unless Mickey decides to move back to hide it behind the wall or something.
Yeah, I'm gonna be sad. You know what, I'm fucking tempted because I don't want to get rushed by a goblin. But I'm gonna trust Sarah to block the attack for me since she doesn't know I robbed her. So she's got no reason not to.
I'll take my payment, thanks.
1, 2. I gotta move. So you got to.
Okay. There, oh yeah, the goblin immediately tries to shoot you. And you're moving out of the way, so it's just an... I think it's a disadvantage because he has such a short chance.
Yeah, wall is it's like a cover. Extra AC.
Really, yeah, they should do that. It's one third. Yeah, it's 3/4 because you are moving away immediately after, so he has a small chance of hitting you. Not that button. There we go. He tries to shoot you!
15 is not that...
Not nearly enough. The arrow just goes past.
3, 4... 1, 2, 3, 4... 5... 6... Can't see anything. Oh well...
Yeah, you... Actually... Yet. You can just barely see this goblin here.
Oh really?
Just barely. A little bit of it. See? From your point of view, he has half protection there.
So no problem, I gotta cast a Crack Flame.
Okay. Oh god.
Let it be damage! 2 damage!
No, now I gotta hit it. Ooh!
7! Holy shit, almost max.
Oh shit.
Okay, deck saving throw here.
Please.
Finally. You hit the goblin there, and your flame bursts him to completely aflame, and he burns to the ground.
Wow. Nice.
There's one goblin down! Don't mess with the cleric.
Is he unconscious or is he dead?
The goblin is completely dead.
I mean, he got burned to ashes. I don't think he'll come back.
Burn like flame!
Ah, look! You can still hear him screaming while he's dying. Plop.
Creaming.
Oh, wow.
Creaming! He's creaming the crown!
Creaming himself!
Okay, now I need to see what was the speed on wolves. 40, okay. That would be... 10... Eight. 20... 13... 40 and attacking Sarah.
You can certainly try.
Here comes a bite!
Here comes a bite. 15, it just about hits.
Okay, and you must succeed on a DC 11 saving strength saving throw.
Did someone say suck?
This should work.
Yeah.
Yeah!
You're only taking the damage then, don't worry. Bite!
That's...
Two damage.
Two damage. Meh!
It's just biting you! Straight through your armor.
Whoops! Wrong amount.
Oh my god, you're almost dead!
There we go!
Well, you're still almost dead, so don't worry about it.
How much HP do you have?
I still have 4.
No! You guys are allowed to say it here? Okay.
Well, you're allowed to say it, but only... You're not allowed to say it for another character. Character himself can say how much health he has left.
But yeah, us in the other section.
You can see a lot of bruises and cuts on her.
Yeah.
The
characters can just see her. She is really hurt.
Yeah, in our other D&D sessions, that's how we say how low somebody is. We just basically describe their health state.
Okay.
And we completely avoid saying anything about HP.
Okay, that's interesting. I like that.
Okay. Let's do that then. So, no more saying about numbers then.
Okay. Yep.
Kill it! You're the last one up there.
Ah, perfect. I'm gonna move sideways so that the fucking shield is still in the way.
Okay.
Giving them a disadvantage on attack, so let's see. I should be able to move right here. That's 6.
That's such a weird way of moving, though.
Well, I can't block Ringo, and I can't go over him with my tin can.
Moving like that, one piece at a time, you could just normally move it by dragging it with your mouse, so...
Yeah, but I like to, it's just a habit so that the DM knows the exact path I'm going to, so you can count the squares just in case.
Yeah, it's a good way.
Use your dash action if you want, so you can move double.
Yeah. Oh, right, I can use my action for that. Alright, I'll do that. I'm going to move myself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Instead, right here.
Well, you have another card.
And, yeah, I just use my action to move, and I'll just stand here and end my action.
Yeah. Okay. So the goblins from the entrance. Arrow slits are just grumbling, moaning and stuff, so on. Not really doing too much there. And da-da-da-da-da-da! That's 10... 20... 30... 40, attacking Killith. And since there's another wolf nearby,
oh shit.
He gets wait. Am I mistaking this for some other character? I thought wolves had advantage when they have friends nearby.
Yep.
That's Hearthstone.
No, they have
It's also in this game, but
I just forgotten to write it up, so let me just quickly add it here.
Okay.
Yeah, back tactics.
Because yeah, barbarians have later on if they take the
Look at this spellcaster going with Wingardium Leviosa. Furiously typing, what-ha!
I'm fairly fast at writing, so...
Yeah, I know how it feels, but now I understand how other people hear it when I'm typing. It's funny.
Okay, so... There we go. Pack tactics. The wolf has an advantage on attack roll against a creature if at least one of the wolf's allies is within 5 feet of the creature and the ally isn't incapacitated.
So, they do get an advantage?
Yeah, yep. They get an advantage against you right now.
On this Bring it!
Oh.
22.
Holy shit.
Okay, I should not have said that.
Now you need to do a DC 11 strength saving throw or be knocked prone.
So how do I do a DC 11 strength?
Strength save. Click strength save.
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
The thing you were doing earlier.
Oh, nice.
Okay, you don't get knocked prone, it just bites through your armor, basically.
How much?
He bites you for...
Bam, 12. Oh.
I'm gonna go ahead and laugh at him for that.
Scumbag.
Ringo!
Give me a sec.
He's fapping.
Oh, I was typing.
He only needs a sec for that.
Okay. If I stand... Okay, if I move here... Over here, this square. If I shoot my fireball or firebolt, will I be able to accidentally hit Sarah? Hello?
Huh?
I mean, what are Hello? You going to hit there? That's a corner.
What? I mean, no, okay. I'm gonna move 2 squares. If I shoot the wolf that's in the corner, like that one, yeah.
Yeah.
I can hit that, right?
Yeah, you should be able to hit that.
Okay, I'm just gonna roll my fireball. My firebolt. I keep saying fireball. It's...
Don't say fireball because it's one of the strongest spells in early
that
levels.
That spell is fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Explosion!
It also will kill every single person in this area if you cause a fireball in this area right
of
now.
Of course you would say that.
Okay. Oh, wait. Do we have any... No, fuck it.
Bird!
Wait. I was gonna try to shoot that guy. Firebolt.
Oh!
That definitely hits, and it's a critical, so you can roll for the damage there.
Okay. Oh, shit. Oh,
burn!
Do you want to picture how your firebolt does this kill?
I just swing my wand and I don't know if he disintegrates, but it goes right in his face.
Yeah, pretty much the fireball just flies towards the wolf, explodes and surrounds and swallows the wolf at the collision. And you can just hear whimpers and scared barks and stuff. And suddenly there's just a rotten corpse of a wolf there with blood just dripping out of it. Rip nice. Wolf number 2. Felt the heat of that flame. Crispy! And this is... Oh! I do have a sound effect for this, actually.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Dinner is served.
That's beautiful. There you go.
Okay.
Do you still have a little bit of movement left if you still
want to? Oh, yeah.
Stay there behind everything.
Yeah, I think I'm
fine. Oh, yeah. Here. Dead enemies and characters are counted as no obstacles, so you can stop into a slot with a dead enemy in it.
Yeah. No way that I'm gonna go there though.
Yeah, but that's for future reference. If you feel like the dead enemies are like just like the floor, so there's no need to worry about it. That's just the floor. Yep. Just walk over the dead enemies.
Yes.
Feel the blood in your feet.
Okay. Next.
Sarah.
Next.
Well.
Your enemy just died in front of you.
Ah, my kill. Nah. Well, she just charges ahead. 1, 2.
The Rex gets an attack of opportunity if you go that far.
Oh, there was an. Fucking hell, I can't see the fucking wolf with the name on it.
Let me get.
Well, it says wolf there.
How do you ping? How does that work?
Just hold left mouse button down.
Ah, that's better. That's better.
Okay. Oh. Oh.
How do I ping? I don't.
Just hold left that's mouse button down.
We all just said it like.
I don't fucking listen, alright?
Wow. She takes her Morningstar and attacks the wolf.
Well then. And it hits quite well. More piercing damage there.
Smack. That's quite low. That's minimum.
That is minimal.
The wolf is just like, well. He takes the hit like a man. Like a wolf.
Like a wolf?
Without even moving. A little bit of an eats there.
Oh, you're dead soon enough.
Okay, Goblin 2 moves to Vision and shoots Shara.
Bring Goblin 2 dead.
And it misses.
That's another goblin.
It misses.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's not Goblin 2.
And the Goblin goes.
It hits my shield.
Yeah. And the goblin goes back to the shadows.
Fucking coward.
And this goblin does absolutely nothing. Is goblin 3 actually charges in with his weapon.
Oh shit.
And attacks Sarah with melee.
Bring it!
Bring it, bitch.
Nope.
You just block it easily. Yeah? Whatever, this useless goblin. Oh, let me. The wolf is actually up on top, so I'll just. Now the wolf is running the dead wolf.
He just crawled under the wolf and attacked.
He gets ultimate shielding of a dead corpse. Mickey!
Well.
Yes! It's me!
There's pretty much one slot for you to attack from, and that's. Above Sarah.
I got a bow though.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna shoot that wolf with my bow. Actually, that goblin can attack me. I'm gonna stab that goblin in the face.
If you don't move into that upper slot, then you will have to shoot past your friends, and that will give the enemy extra
ammo. Yeah, you need to move.
I'm not moving. I'm gonna stab the goblin in the face.
You need to move for that too. You're not close enough.
Where do I need to move?
You need to move at least 5 feet away from the enemy, and this is the only slot you can stop in.
Fine, I'll do that, and I'm gonna stab the goblin in the face.
Do it!
Okay, let's roll. Thank.
Fucking Ringo.
Oh, it hits. Your attack hits.
I'm gonna deal damage one attack, or...
Click on the sword there. Also, you get the sneak attack on because you have friends around.
Oh shit, what the hell?
I'm gonna do that.
And now add the sneak attack damage.
No, sneak attack's a separate thing. I get the second attack for sneak attack.
No, yeah, no, sneak attack is an extra
do
damage.
I...
You get the extra sneak attack out because you have friends nearby.
So what do? I just add fucking, do I roll a d6?
Yeah, 1d6,
yeah.
Nope, that's the wrong one.
Yeah, it came there.
Yeah, there's 1d6 there. You do a total of 8 damage, and first of all, you can actually describe this yourself. It's dead. It's completely dead. It's so dead, the goblin. So dead, the goblin. That's a good name for the next goblin.
So, describe it.
Okay. So, I just got kick it in the jaw, and its jaw falls off, and it dies.
Okay.
Wow.
That works, I guess. You're not even using your weapons. It's fine. Okay, do you want to move more, or there's a chance for you to move into the blood spot with the two corpses in if you want to go there?
I'm gonna move back where I was.
Okay. Light to the people. Lucina! There's a pile of corpses there now.
Yeah, I gotta go there.
Loot it.
Loot it.
You can see the goblin.
Hello! I gonna smack him with my mace.
Do
you
it.
Can't see it.
He's surprised to see you come through. Oh yeah, you went past the red. Actually, there's an attack of opportunity to you, by the way.
Hit him.
Wait, the Rex first, because you went past him.
Yes, it's hit.
He has the bite.
Ooh, he's gonna hit me.
Okay, do the strength saving throw then. You might actually end up being on the blood spill there.
Ooh, it's weird. There you are.
Nah, yeah. It just bites you and you just trip yourself past it. You're almost dead! You're
Holy
almost
shit.
Dead!
These wolves are pretty nasty, actually.
Yeah. They are! The Rex, the one I named Rex actually has almost the highest possible health roll you can do for a wolf.
Well then!
You attack the goblin there, go ahead.
Yeah.
12. He easily blocks your attack.
Oh. Too bad.
Rip.
1, 2, 3, 4. I can move. Huh?
Do you really want to move so he can do an attack of opportunity?
Do it from there. It's still in 5 feet range.
Yeah. I'm gonna hide here and...
Now you're on 5 feet between Rex and the goblin.
Oh well. Oh well.
Ouch.
Wolf 2 is dead. Never mind. Kill
Fuck
it.
You, Wolfie.
There's a Rex next to you.
Yeah, he should have. He should have 4 damage already.
Oh, nice.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Yep. Roll for the damage.
Oh, he's dead. He's dead.
I slap
the wolf
my axe.
Takes your axe like a man.
You monster!
The wolf looks extremely hurt, but is still barely hanging
it's still
on.
Alive?
It's still alive.
Well, how did I kill the first wolf then?
I rolled like the minimal possible health on it.
Yeah.
I randomized the health for all of the characters according to the rules.
Right.
Just you wait, little wolfie.
So two goblins never have the same health unless I get really lucky with the rolls. Because
that's
they
nice, actually.
Basically roll 1d6 for their health.
But is it like between like... Is there like a big buffer between the minimal and high? Like...
Wolf health is 2d8 plus 2.
Oh, okay. Before 4 HP.
Ouch.
Yeah, the first wolf actually had 5.
Of course, I'm the one stuck with this one. Anyway,
Rex actually got angry for your attack and bites you back. And he no longer has back tactics because you killed the.
For fuck's sake!
Holy fuck, dude! These fucking wolves need to go to a fucking casino.
These
dude.
Guys are not fucking.
This is a Rex. This is a freaking Rex.
Jesus Christ.
Strength save.
Yeah,
do the strength save as well.
Okay.
Yep. You barely may avoid being.
I fall down on my knee. Fucking.
And then it just throws back up.
I'm panting, falling down on my knee because I'm injured. Like, what the fuck? Stupid wolf.
Ringo! Your friends are slowly going down.
1, 2, 3?
Yep. Now you're next to the wolf there, so...
Yeah. And I'm gonna cast another fucking Firebolt!
What if you miss?
By the way, it's a disadvantage. Isn't it a disadvantage?
Is
no,
it?
No, not yet.
But yeah, when is it disadvantage, then?
When you're at 5 feet against the enemy when you use a ranged attack.
Oh, is it? Oh. Well, didn't know.
Oh yeah, it is, I think.
Okay, so...
If I remember right.
At least your concentration can be challenged if you're next to an enemy and trying to cast something.
Let's see. D&D 5e spell range. Jeez. Ranged attacks in close combat, aiming a ranged attack is more difficult when a foe is next to you. When you make a ranged attack with a weapon, a spell, or some other means, you have disadvantage on that attack roll if you are within 5 feet of a hostile creature who can see you and who isn't incapacitated. Okay. This is from the player's handbook.
Okay, so
if
13...
you move there and shoot, that's not gonna work.
It's not gonna work? It's not?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's not gonna hit. Yeah.
Can I
actually, never mind. It is gonna hit.
Oh shit!
Oh shit.
Just barely. You hit it. Just barely.
Okay. Yay.
Burn.
Your firebolt engulfs the wolf like the last one, and it whimpers and dies.
Ah, poor doggy.
Okay. Can I still loot or something?
That
would
be an accent.
Okay, I'm just gonna go back then. Oh, fuck, I'm still
you're stuck in the ball.
I'll just say thank you for taking that one down. And yeah. I'm still panting, heavily injured.
You're welcome.
Okay. Sarah.
Well.
Wait, can I still look around and see what this is up here? I have no fucking clue.
That's a rock. Like, that's
your
a
turn's
rock.
Already ended.
That's a rock.
Yeah, that's a rock.
Oh. Yeah.
What's up, dog?
Goblin, go ahead.
Yeah. Hello, goblin.
Yeah.
I want to see. I cannot see. I'm just gonna stand here. But I'm standing up here. But I wouldn't. I just want to see.
Yeah, you can reach out like that just to see what's happening.
Temporarily stand here.
Yeah, the goblin just blocks it with his sword. Just pushes it off like nothing.
No.
And he attacks you back.
What? He has a counter?
No, it's his turn after you.
Alright.
Wait. Oh, 120 feet? Holy fuck, dude. Yeah. I was thinking, like, how far can I shoot him? Apparently I can shoot 120
it hits.
Feet.
Oh, it does hit?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's a... Oh, just about... And she falls down.
You have 4 health. You're on -4 now.
No, it's halved. It's halved.
Oh yeah, halved. Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody.
The goblin hits Sarah and pretty much just she just falls unconscious and clearly close to death into the ground there. This is going really well for you guys right now.
Hell yeah.
Sarcasm.
I'm actually pretty shocked at this point.
Yeah, we better level up twice at least.
Yeah.
Okay. The goblin, after taking care of Sarah, does the... Oh no.
Oh,
he tries to move, but Lucina gets an attack of opportunity from it.
Ooh, nice. Hit him.
Ooh. Oh, let's bring him back.
Wait, what's that? Oh, your mace. Oh shit, dude. 9 damage? That's a lot.
The goblin tries to avoid your attack, but you hit him on the head and you can hear his brains scrunching.
You mean his skull?
Brains off. Just please blast brains off.
Why do you hit my friend?
Trip.
Crunchy brain food.
Well then. Then, over there, nothing too much happens. Just... Come on, freaking...
Crunchy brain.
See
you. Oh, that would be so awesome. Okay, what
this
next?
This would be good. Okay.
We are waiting for goblins.
The goblins are doing their moves. Mickey!
Yes! Okay, I'm gonna hang on. Wait a minute. Alright, so I'm gonna go here. And I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna go here.
Exactly. Where's here? You're just standing still for me.
Oh, there. In the wall. Right. Okay.
Shut up. Are there any alive goblins? Can't see any. Hey, what's this green thing?
Do you want to save me?
Do you that's want to some leaves or something in the ground.
Where are the alive goblins?
They are all dead.
No, they're not all dead yet.
No.
There's three left.
Two at the entrance guards.
Okay, this room, like the previous room, this one contains mostly bedrolls and few discrete furnishings where the goblins rest and relax when not out doing their terrible things that goblins do. Three cages against the wall east wall, between the doors, two of which were housed with a wolf. And
I have to save Sarah, I don't know how to do that.
You can use your action to make a medicine skill check that will stabilize me.
You need to roll 10 or higher.
Don't do it. I gotta heal.
I'm not gonna do it because it's not in my character's best interest. And I'm gonna move this way and I'm gonna move this way. Do I see any goblins yet?
No.
For fuck's sake! Fine, I'll I don't know. I'm just gonna ring my bell because why the fuck not? I've got a bell. I'm ringing it.
Ring, ring.
Ring my bell. That's
hello.
You're not gonna pickpocket you with all these people looking at me. I'll get fucking stabbed again.
Why don't you use a turn to loot everything?
Fuck off, I'm not looting fucking wolves, what are they gonna give me?
One gold.
Wolf meat.
Wolf meat.
Well, if you're proficient, you could.
There's two goblins on
it's
the ground.
It's too late, I've already rung my bell.
Okay.
Okay, next.
Let's go.
Gonna heal. Healing word.
The good thing is that Sarah is out of her bloodlust because of this race.
Yeah.
Oh, yay! Nice.
6 health, you're back alive!
That was my last healing. No more healing.
Oh, fuck.
Oh my.
So...
That's alright.
Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Ringo makes robot crying sounds.
Do it!
No. This is the greatest, I think.
Those are always more game. Oh, wait. They are...
What is this?
These things here are the cages, and the things in the sides there are... Are? Where does it read?
It's so sad that I cannot see anything. I just see like a little bit, and I don't have a light source.
Yeah, that's how it goes sometimes. I'm so sad.
Well,
they're basically just doors. That's all. They're just
doors.
Yeah, they're normal wooden doors.
Okay.
Because this doesn't really tell me anything what they should be, so I'm just telling that they're doors.
Yo.
Oh crap. There's goblins here. Oh no. I gotta say.
The moment you go there, the goblin number 2 shoots at you.
Oh no.
Oh dear.
Rip.
He's the only one with the bow left, so.
Okay.
It misses.
I block it.
Nice.
I gonna hit sacred frame to her face.
Okay.
Burn in the righteous fire. Oh,
the number 2, you mean?
Yeah.
Your sacred frame just burns him into crisp. It dies in the spot.
No, I forgot
about that. Never mind. Oh. Let me get the health back.
Damn it!
Thank you for reminding me. I'm the best DM
before
ever.
Exactly 13. 15.
Yeah, it
okay, looks at your flames! Pretty lights again. This is the same goblin, by the way.
This time, more brightly. More brightly this time.
Pretty lights, stupid human.
Oh. God damn it. Hey, I gonna stay here.
Yeah. Kill it! You heard fighting noises from up ahead.
Oh. Go hard or go home, guys.
You're almost dead.
1, 2, 4, 6.
You can go through that. You could have gone from there. Just saying.
Yeah, but it's not like he really wants to go there, so.
I mean, I could. If I'm suicidal.
This goblin tries to shoot Lucina again.
Oh no.
Ringo sneaking.
What?
Yeah, I'm trying to see more.
Does it hit?
It's very dark.
Miss, okay.
You're not allowed to see.
18, it's armor class.
Okay. So yeah, it tries to shoot you, it clanks off of your armor, just effortlessly stopping it. Ringo!
Yes,
you hear sounds in there, you're in the darkness. You've been left behind.
I loot this goblin.
That's an action if you go through it.
Oh.
Yeah. It's like an investigation check.
Wait.
Sure, no. Search or investigation. Shit, like
1, 2, 3, 4. I loot this goblin.
Okay.
So you're gonna loot that one.
Okay, let's see.
Oh shit. I rolled a 10.
You find a goblin's used, bad, ugly looking scimitar, a short bow, and 2 copper pieces.
Oh shit, 2 copper.
More copper. To throw away the key.
Yo,
normally they wouldn't be carrying any money at all, but I'm a happy DM because you're almost dead anyway.
Oh shit. I decide to dump the short bow and the scimitar on the ground because I don't need it.
Yeah.
You don't even care about picking them up. Yeah.
Yeah, I know, right?
And
I walked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's a green puddle on the ground. 6.
That's green puddle is just grass or something.
Yeah? It's not gonna be a trap? Okay, I'm gonna stand on it.
Mushroom.
Okay, Sarah, you're back on your feet. You heard fighting sounds up ahead.
Yep. She could see that. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
Be back 10 seconds.
Hello!
You attacked the goblin right in front of you.
Hello.
Hello.
And he also attacks you back, by the way, because he was readying in case someone came too close.
Nice.
Funny, so you hit each other at the same time. That hits.
Nope!
And he hits you at the same time.
Lala, do we do both fall
on
the ground? Oh fuck!
Oh shit, dude.
Yeah, you managed to push your weapon through the goblin's body at the same time while he accidentally manages to push his through yours, so.
God damn it, guys.
Morningstar through the fucking body. Oh,
holy shit.
I'd rather just smack him in the head.
Yeah. Through the body! There's nothing left of that goblin.
One punch!
Yes. Basically. There's still goblin too. Just ghosting around in this list. The last goblin gets super angry and charges Lucina with his melee weapon.
Uh-oh.
I sure that's a, that's a different
please goblin. Don't kill me.
That's a different goblin. Dude. That's a different goblin.
Yeah.
Oh, wait.
Goblin Entrance Guard 2 has 9.
God dang it, this is the wrong one.
Goblins, yeah.
This is the dead one. I keep mixing those up sometimes. Okay, Mickey, your turn instead.
Alright, okay, so like... like one... Two... Three... Four... And I'm gonna like, try and shoot the goblin with my bow.
Okay.
So,
calling it one.
It hits easily. You're so skilled with the bow. You can roll the damage that you need.
Something he can do.
You snipe the goblin in the head and it falls down dead in the ground.
Nice.
I didn't get to kill Lucina, dang it.
Almost.
You got me down twice.
Okay.
There's three people who almost died here.
For now, there is no enemies in sight that you know of.
We should revive,
I'm gonna do it.
We should not.
I'm gonna do it.
Okay.
No problem. There you go.
Yep, you're back. Does it go into zero health?
Zero health and you recall in 1d4 hours.
Yeah. 1d4 hours, okay.
Let me roll that for you.
No, I can roll. I'm rolling.
3 hours!
Nice, guys! Game has decided that you're gonna be sleeping for 3 hours.
I'm gonna pick her up. Pick Sarah up.
No, just fucking leave her there, it's fine.
Can you lift, hold on, it's 75 with the gear plus weight.
I'm just using my strength save, look at strength save.
And 88, how much that is in LPS?
You need to use normal strength if you want to do it, so.
Yeah, but if it goes within his strength limit, it should be fine.
I can't help. End up getting stabbed by a goblin and die.
I go loot the goblin.
Just fucking leave it.
Okay, let's see.
Let me see. I wanna.
Literally find smelly rags.
Oh.
You can't even see the weapons this time.
I go down and loot this one.
You don't have to roll for investigation because this is just purely me doing it. Okay. That goblin had nothing either.
Oh shit. So what do we do? Are we gonna look around and see what we find in this room? I'm not sure what these three things on the right side are. Is it like stalls? Like little...
There's nothing valuable here. It's just a goblin crab, basically.
Okay.
Yeah. Like goblin stalls.
Which door are we taking?
This one.
Do we take the left door or the right door?
This one.
Let's take the bottom one because Mickey told us to go for the top door. Who agrees with me?
I agree.
Sarah. Okay. I'll suck a cog and go up to the top door.
I'm carrying Sarah with me the entire time.
Yo, I'm just gonna be paranoid and I'm just gonna cast Mage Hand to open this door. Can I?
Mage Hand points at stuff, I think it was.
Can I not?
No, Mage Hand can manipulate objects. Open an unlocked door. Yeah, it's a different spell. It's a guiding hand or something like that.
But I also have that one. This is a cantrip.
I'm preparing the room ahead.
Oh shit, no, I have to move it 30 feet. 1, 2,
what the
three.
Fuck is this? Don't peek!
No peeking.
Wait, I move 2, and then I use my Mage Hand to open it from here.
Okay,
I can move it 30 feet. Well, then again, we don't really use action, so because we're
just move it. So let me move the door open
time.
For you.
It does take time.
June.
Nothing happened.
I wish I had a potion with me.
Me too.
Oh wait, don't you have one potion?
Yeah, I was about to say. We have a potion.
Yeah, oh, I've got it.
Yeah, Mickey has the potion.
No,
I'm gonna drink the potion because I'm also low on health.
Wow.
Okay.
I'm not, but I'm not gonna give it to her. She can fuck off. She punched me in the face!
Yeah, you tried to rob her.
You did rob her.
Mm-hmm. I didn't give her a flying fuck, she doesn't know that.
Okay, I think we should go.
Yep. Let's go first.
Just decide the order that you're going in. You can fit in one.
I go through this door. I don't want to go through the bottom door. Fuck that.
Well, you can open the door then.
Want to go first?
I open the door then. I open.
Or do you want to carry Sarah? Mm-hmm. I can go first if you want to take over Sarah.
So,
should I just go?
You can move around the same time as other people. So yeah. Go ahead, you can move like 3 squares now. Mickey moves 3 squares.
Just now you can move a few more. She's quite heavy with all the stuff on her.
Okay, Mickey sees the goblins and the goblins see you and they're shooting at you.
Help me?
You're the first one standing there.
Can I backtrack?
You can try to dodge these arrows because they are suppress arrows, so
okay,
roll your dodge here.
So is that a dex saving frag?
Yeah, dex save at this point.
Close that door, please, when you run.
13, let's see.
You're the one behind.
No, I mean Mickey. If he's running away from goblins.
You don't know that. He's far away.
All three arrows from the three goblins miss you.
Yeah.
You manage to back up enough so that they don't see you. So you basically go somewhere like that.
They can still see me.
No, they cannot anymore. You're squeezing on the wall. The people down there will hear goblin voices and arrows flying, basically.
Oh, crap.
Looks like that room did something again.
And there's also a bigger voice or something bigger yelling orders there in Goblinoid.
Shit's gonna be nasty. Come on through the door. We're clear for now.
Oh, yeah.
Also, Mickey saw the room, so I'm gonna tell what's in there. The room itself is better furnished than the previous rooms, with some serviceable tables and chairs, some palatable food and drink, and even a larger chair sitting on a granite slab at the far end. Several passages lead out of the room, deeper into the cave. Some goblins stand around in the room, all looking for direction from a larger bugbear. Two large cages at the back of the room hold the 11 prisoners taken from the Peatbug farm. In addition, a human dressed in black underclothing, the kind you would typically wear for Under Armour, is caged. So there's 12 prisoners in this room.
Oh wow. What do I see, by the way?
You see these weird mushroom things in the ground there.
Oh, those are mushrooms. Okay.
Mushrooms? Oh shit.
I guess they have to be. So yeah. Do you go... not so fast.
Oh, not so fast? Okay.
Everyone else needs to move a little bit as well. So, the moment you go there, you hear goblin voices again, and now we need to roll for the initiative here.
Oh shit.
So, everyone rolling.
Initiative, okay.
Rolling time.
20?
Oh, fucking interesting.
Mm-hmm. Do I have to because I'm still unconscious and I...
You might, yeah. You don't have to.
Holy shit!
Oh fuck!
Wait, oh, does shit. Mickey also need to roll?
I already rolled!
Ringo, you forgot to highlight your character so your initiative isn't registered.
Oh fuck.
Okay.
DM should be able to change it.
Yeah,
I can do it. So Ringo's number was
again?
20.
Just highlight your character and roll it again.
Yay!
No, I'm gonna add it manually, so don't do it.
Oh, okay, don't do anything.
I fucked up my first
Ringo.
Ringo.
Fucking Ringo.
Ringo.
Don't do anything.
You
okay, does everything. Yeah, he's 20.
Oh, no, it's on 20. Okay.
So did everyone longer? Have their rolls now? 2, 3. Yeah, everyone's rolling. Descending order. Get it, Rip.
Rip all.
I'm gonna be fucked over, man. Fuck this.
There is a goblin shooting at you. I just closed everything.
Oh, here we go.
Okay. Shooting at you with an arrow.
Oh, shit, 19. For fuck's sake, that's a hit.
Aim before crit.
Yeah,
critical miss. 6 damage, that's enough to take you down, don't you?
How you can see Kirith in front of you getting an arrow through his body and just toppling over.
Oh shit, dude.
Holy shit.
I just want to... Can I just do this one? I fall down on my knees and I just knock out that way because my shield is holding me.
okay, you have
such I want to go down like a badass.
okay. You're kneeling on your shield there, hanging onto it while unconscious. And this goblin moves a little bit and shoots Mickey O'Neill.
Okay.
this lucky bitch.
Just
the goblin's bow pretty much just crackles into pieces and smites the goblin itself into the head.
Of course.
With a full 4 damage.
All the fucking good hits.
And because of the strength of the hit, the goblin also gets knocked prone into the ground.
Oh wow.
Into the ground.
You fucking wrecked goblin.
Okay, it's my turn. Is it?
Yeah, the goblin curses that these useless weapons. Bingo!
Okay. 1, 2.
When you go
three.
Through another person, it takes the extra double movement, so that's 10 feet.
Extra.
Yep.
Yeah, so, 1, 2.
Yep.
3. 4.
Yeah.
I can't see, it's not. I don't have light.
Yeah, exactly, fuck. You can't see anything.
Fuck.
Also, you're being kind of suicidal right now.
No way,
you're all being kind of suicidal, just going into the boss fight.
Fuck. I think I'm gonna shoot this way. Can I shoot what I cannot see? Like...
You can, show me with the ruler the direction you plan on shooting on, and I will tell if it's possible or not.
Here.
You're gonna shoot that way, it's gonna be a disadvantage shot, of course, so try it. I'm gonna tell you if it's gonna hit or not.
Shoot!
Okay, give me a sec. Spellbook. Oh, wait.
If you're casting a spell that needs a target, you cannot do that.
I cannot?
You cannot see the target.
Yeah, but the firebolt is if
you
it's
can
a fireball.
Just randomly throw it.
Yeah. But
Should
you need
I just
to actually
ice
have attack attempt there if you're doing it now.
Should I go for Ice Knife and AoE the shit out of people?
Go ahead. I mean,
right.
Go for it.
Your call.
Eight.
You're the mage.
You shoot it
eight.
Randomly over there, and Mickey O'Neill sees a small icy explosion over there in the wall.
Bang.
Wait. If I can, will not AoE still?
Yeah, there is still the AoE, but it doesn't mean
it. It doesn't mean anything's in the range of it, so.
Yeah, but can I not remotely, like, press the button to that? No, okay, whatever. Fuck it. No, I wasted it on stall skill. Fucking. Okay. And I'm like, oh shit, I'm really afraid. And I'm like, fucking go back. Wait. Give me a sec.
Did you hit something?
1, 2,
in general,
3,
no?
4, 5.
You
can
follow
me
there, yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Okay.
Wait, you killed something or did you miss something?
No, I miss it.
He missed everything pretty much.
Aww.
And this goblin goes into the light and shoots at Ringo.
Oh shit, I'm dead.
Oh shit!
No.
Okay, I'm fine.
The shot actually hits the mushrooms in the front and just stops there for some reason. For no reason at all, the small mushrooms stopped the bullet.
I have 12 AC.
I need to draw my character now. Fuck it all.
Mickey!
Oh yes. Shit, I should have healed you, dude.
I'm gonna, like, pop out here. Okay. Wait, yeah. Who's Garunk?
Garunk is the bugbear you saw in the room.
I'm gonna shoot at Goblin 1 with my bow.
Oh shit, now I can see!
And I'm going to pop my inspiration so I can advantage roll.
Well then.
Oh
well
yeah,
then.
I could have.
Oh, wait.
Oh!
People forget that they have inspiration points to use for one round.
Oh, right!
Wait, I couldn't have used it. Anyways, right? I couldn't have.
You were at disadvantage, so.
It would have still hit? Because the disadvantage would be gone.
You get a critical hit at Goblin 1.
And sneak attack because of the advantage.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, dude, this is not. This
roll
is not
damage
fair.
And then roll sneak attack.
Oh, lol.
Double sneak. 2d6. Roll 2d6 because it's a critical.
Yep.
That's still 10 damage.
Did I do it wrong?
Roll it again.
Slash roll
it's, 2d6. Together.
On, yeah, together. Oh, yeah. Without space between.
So, 2d6. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. There oh, 10 damage now.
There we go.
Okay. Nice. 18. Yeah, the goblin, you shoot so hard that the body pretty much just, it goes straight through the goblin and just topples into the ground.
I should have shot Garunk.
The goblin got minus 13 health right now, so.
Holy shit.
Wow,
he's shitty. I'm gonna hide back into my hole then.
Well.
Ah, Lucina.
Oh crap. I gotta drop Shara first.
If you drop him, you don't lose an action, but he'll have to roll for his life one extra time. But if you put him down carefully, you will have to use your action for that.
God damn it!
You mean!
Oh shit, dude.
I am a mean one. You're the ones who went in without having a small rest before.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Well, shit.
Reap what you sow.
Well, I gotta still drop.
Okay.
You gotta drop.
So.
Yeah, I could have.
Sarah will roll for his life, her life right now.
Oh shit.
Oh yeah, I took damage, so I have to start rolling death saves again. But
this death save comes because it drops you in the ground while you're on this unstable condition.
Yay!
You get one plus there. It was a positive roll down. You should drop people more often.
Well, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2.
Yeah, but do I have to still roll my death saves?
Yes, you do.
Shit.
As long as nobody stabilizes you, you're gonna have to roll the death saves. Oh yeah, you don't have to because.
1, 2.
I was stabilized, but.
You don't have to roll them more than that, but if someone tramples over you, then you might need to roll one again.
Okay. Let's see. What's my Sacred Flames range? It's 60 feet.
You can see Goblin 2 there, so. Can you see Goblin
2? I see all.
Wait, where the fuck are you?
I see everything.
He is on top of Killith at the moment.
Yeah. Well, there's. I can see, like, what Mickey is. I see that Goblin 3 here.
You don't really see what Mickey sees, so. If I move Mickey away, but this is what you see.
Yeah, but the light is.
You have the dim light, so you can still see it, I guess.
I think. I don't know. Well.
You cannot see Mickey's light because you are not Mickey. Hey, oh, wait! Never mind!
Of course I can't see Mickey's light.
Of course you can. Ah, freaking torches! I keep forgetting how torches work. That's such a complicated mechanic.
It is, isn't it?
Of course I can see other lights, you know?
Never mind, you can see
Do I have enough, any frame? 1, 2, 3, four,
I'm too
five,
used to her dark vision, because everyone on the other team has a dark vision, except for one pony.
Nobody in the other team, except for two of us, has dark vision.
3, 4, 5, 6. I can hit Goblin 3 here.
Okay. Wait. You'll get an advantage on that because he's already down.
Why did you kill Goblin 2 though?
Because it never been attacked before, I guess.
You
know whose turn it's gonna be after yours?
Do I? I don't see Shadow of Gorunk, but.
You don't see him correctly yet? Everyone else is just trading for it.
Okay.
It's your call, boy.
My mission is to kill evil, so let's kill evil.
Okay. Go ahead.
Let's hit the boss.
Ooh.
No. No, wrong.
Not Sacred Flame?
Wrong.
No, yes, but...
Oh shit, 7.
Not roll at the damage.
Okay, let's see Dex save intro.
12.
Oh fuck.
Oh nice.
It hits for 7 damage.
Bugbear.
You get him burning for a while and he puts it off while it's a stealing for pain.
Damn. I'm so gonna die.
And he's kinda angry.
I'm sorry I couldn't help you.
I'm so gonna die. Oh well.
And he rushes you. And as you know...
Oh god!
Bugbears are brutes. A melee weapon deals one extra die of its damage when the bugbear hits with it. It's included in the attack.
Oh shit.
Also... This doesn't matter because it's not a surprise attack. Okay. So... It pretty much just goes at you.
Oh, Jesus.
And punches please you with me. A morning
please
star.
Don't hit me.
Crit.
Misses!
You are so lucky!
Look at it! Hoot, my shield.
He's baby. Very angry. Kill it, you need to roll for your life. You need to make a death save roll.
Yep, I'm on it. I'm holding my balls right now, Jesus Christ.
It's a positive one.
Oh, I was literally holding my breath.
If you had fumbled that though, oh my god.
Would you have been dead?
No, one fumble is 2 negatives. So...
What? And you need to roll 3 to die.
You need 3 to die or be alive, so if he gets a critical 20 now, he will be immediately stabilized. But he also can still have 3 negatives if he keeps getting those in a row.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, goblin number 1 is dead.
Dead.
Goblin number 3... Wait. Back to goblin number 3. Gets up and loses half of his mobility. Is Ornstein coming back yet? Is he back yet?
I don't know.
He said BRB yet? Earlier, so...
Yeah, he's not back, I don't think.
So we will wait, because this is clearly continuing to attack Mickey. With the bow broken though, he charges in.
You can.
And he only makes it this far, because of the half movement.
Oh well.
Rip.
Well, yeah, that's all he does, so... Ringo.
What?
Your turn.
1, 2... What is that...
The boss is right there.
No, it's a brown shit.
The boss is right in front of you.
The hay is... The brown thing is hay.
Hay, okay. Wait, I was here, right? Is that 1, 2, 3, 4... And I shoot... This guy here?
Okay.
My ice knife?
Go ahead.
Give me a sec. Spells. Oh my god, dude. Wait.
Use your... But it does heal, hit the wall behind it, so...
Oh shit! I was gonna... Wait,
yeah, but
which way, though?
It's gonna explode on the spot anyway.
Can I still use my inspiration?
No, not after rolling. No. You need to say it before you roll.
Okay.
God, you miss the goblin completely, but you hit the wall behind, so it explodes there anyways and hits the goblin. The goblin is the only one within 5 feet from that then. So, do the AoE. So, wasn't it that I need to... Yeah, DC 12. That's the thing I was looking for. And let's do... You hit 3 damage into the goblin with the explosion there. He gets shots in his face. In the target location. In that case, it also hits the boss.
Yeah.
Oh, Okay.
Yeah, because it's it just says hit or miss, it explodes.
Yeah. It's.
And he saved.
He saved. He doesn't care.
wait. Is one, it... 2, 3, 4.
No, you I didn't. Move... Mickey is still fine. One, the goblin didn't make it to you yet.
I moved 2 ways back.
Okay. The goblin didn't make it to you yet because he just rose up and moved a little bit forward. That's all.
Good shit.
Good shit.
Goblin 2 goes and assists Gurung.
Got the bed. Please not hit.
Oh god.
Oh shit.
Yes, it hit.
And it's dead.
Yeah, I'm dead.
Wait, that dead?
Not dead.
Not
just dead. Unconscious.
There's only 2 of you left, by the way.
Yeah.
Unconscious.
Fuck, dude. I'm gonna get killed by Gronk.
Oh, don't fucking leave me to do it.
Well, yeah, well, someone has to do it. Someone has to fucking do it.
It's Lucina down too.
Ringo, you can help Ornstein by using the help action. Give advantage to...
This goes right next to Ringo.
Oh shit, dude. Wait, how do I help him?
Distract the shit out of this goblin for me.
Yeah, you can yell for the goblin to try and get it to notice you. Notice me, senpai.
What?
Speaking is a free action, so you can just yell at the goblin if you want.
Yeah, but what helping does... What does it do?
It distracts the goblin, so Mickey will get an attack of advantage on his attack. But this goes for the role-playing, so you better make it good.
Oh, do bear in mind that I basically, like, our only hope, so...
Yo, booger hat. Fuck you.
Oh, okay, roll for intimidation would be a good one, I guess.
Oh, shit. Wait.
Make him confused as fuck.
Intimidation, Oh, it's -1.
Go ahead. Yeah, he doesn't care.
No, are you fucking shitting me, dude? Even my fucking adventure was 4.
Those are beautiful.
Oh,
why
shit.
Why did you use your fucking inspiration, man?
You
I don't know.
Didn't use it this time either, so...
Yeah, well...
The forest not much, so...
Well, Mickey!
It wouldn't even...
Your turn.
Worse.
I'm gonna go and... establish Goblin in the face.
Good
dude,
turn.
I'm gonna die. Unless I'm fucking lucky.
So, how do I stab him? Stab him.
First attack.
Make an attack roll.
Oh my god, those criticals! Again!
Dude.
Roll for damage.
It's like your third 20, dude.
Dude, I can't help being good.
Yeah? You're so good.
Oh fuck, I don't even have... Oh, I don't have any...
By the way, is that advantage for real?
What?
Was that an advantage roll because the other one is grey?
Oh no, I just forgot to change it.
Okay.
Wait, how do you change that?
Yeah, you can change it from the character sheet's options.
It's fine, because it's the first one anyway, so it's still that wrong.
It's always the first one in this
case. How do you...
So yeah, you literally decapitate the goblin.
Okay, that's nice. let's see.
Yo, come closer, help.
Come closer.
No, I don't want to get fucking shot. Alright, so I've still got some movement, so I'm going to peek. And I'm gonna run away. Okay.
Oh no.
This concludes my move. Actually, I'll peek again. And I'll shout, "Oi, dickhead," at Goblin 2.
I'll send it to the
intimidation
Discord
chat.
Intimidation.
You succeed on it! He looks at you very angrily, and since you killed the other one in the ground, he gets really angry and he begins to ready to charge at you. Not only that, but you yelled strong enough. Let's see what the bugbear has to say for this.
You aggro Korok.
Also, the bugbear actually notices you.
Oh, brilliant. I'm gonna hide again.
Lucina.
Lucina!
Do Sarah need to roll that?
I'm stabilized. Yeah, I'm stabilized, but yeah. I just had to throw one.
Okay. Just.
Okay.
Well, because I don't have any inspiration, so it's gonna be.
No, death save.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Oh,
fuck.
Gorank is coming after Mickey now.
Cool. Oh shit! Oh,
it goes past Rinko, so if you want, you can do use your attack of opportunity. But if you do, he might get angry and just start attacking you instead.
Okay.
No, please do it. I don't want him. I don't want to die.
No.
Fuck you!
I'm fucking frozen because I'm scared like shit.
Save my life.
Even robots get scared, dude.
10, 20. He gets this far.
He shot a smoke grenade.
Kill it! Roll for your life.
Oh my god.
Do you have inspiration?
You do.
I don't.
You do. No, you don't.
I don't see it.
Then you don't.
Wait, we had. Oh, wait, no.
I didn't give it to everyone.
No, I didn't.
You gave it to.
Oh! Oh my god!
Yeah. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Okay. Goblin 3 is dead. Dead, I tell you, dead. Ringo!
Time to make your new character!
You have a goblin on your face, but he's ignoring you. You have the chance of actually going and healing people.
Yeah, can you aggro Gorunk for me?
Wait, is Caleb dead?
Not yet, but he will be if he rolls negative again next time.
Okay, so, 1, 2, 3.
And roll for Melisine. You need to get 10 or better.
Oh shit, dude.
He will die if you roll 1, so don't worry about it.
Oh, okay.
You
okay.
Stabilize him. He is not gonna die anymore.
Okay.
1d4.
Oh, I got stabilized?
1, 2, 3.
Oh, I got stabilized!
You're just running away. You're leaving Lucina behind there.
No, Lucina is still making death circles.
Oh no, wait. Okay, so 1, 2, 3.
Four. You can stay behind.
Yes, five. Okay. Okay, I'm done. Yeah. I'm done here.
The goblin comes here. 1, 2.
roll the powers when the kill it gonna.
Oh yeah, 1d4.
1d4.
What?
Can I roll it because I revive him?
When gonna revive? Kill it.
Oh yeah!
Roll that one.
One hour.
Hero will never die.
Wow!
Okay. Goblin 2 moves. He goes up by 2, and forwards by 2. All the way to Mickey O'Neill and tries to attack him.
Coolio.
So how many hours have been passed now? Oh, 9.
It's 6 seconds for a turn, so... You've been here for like 10 minutes, Mad Max.
Mickey O'Neill.
Don't do shit.
Yeah, the attack misses you completely. So, it's your turn.
Well, I'm gonna fucking leg it down this hallway.
When you try to move, there comes an attack of
incident. Oh, well, I forgot about that. Cancel, I changed my mind. I didn't do
that. Hold on. You can use your disengage action.
No. Let him kill it.
It's a rogue squad.
I like how everybody wants him dead.
No, fuck it, man. I'm just going to stab this fucker with my sword.
Okay.
Damn it.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, miss.
Roll the 2.
You missed!
Thanks for giving me advantage, wankers!
But you can still decide to move if you want. The attack of opportunity cannot kill you even if it hits, unless it's a critical hit.
I'm gonna fucking do it, it's not gonna do shit. It's not like it's gonna hit me.
Let's see.
Oh shit, I can see!
The goblin comes after you, trips onto the dead body of his friend, and actually hits himself.
Yay!
For 4 damage. And that's really painful for him. And he's prone because he's just tripped. Also, he's on the way of Gorunk. So.
Uh-oh.
Well played.
I yell, oi, dickhead, what are you doing?
Okay. Lucina! Roll
intimidation.
Roll intimidation.
Yeah, roll intimidation.
Roll... Congratulations, second bonus. And let me try something here. No, never mind. Of course, I'm not with you today.
What if you get a bonus? Or what was a death save bonus?
Nothing, just...
He needs to win a little bit more to actually survive on his her own. Mm-hmm. Gorong is coming here, picks up the goblin and kicks
him.
Pretty much kicks the goblin on the way past and uses his accent to kick it because he's on the way.
Throw him at me.
That would be two accents, so he can't really do that. He does the punches the goblin because he's on the way, and that would be...
One plus his strength.
That would be 3 damage, yeah, the goblin is almost dead. Punches the goblin and the force of the punches moves him back a bit. And
does
that...
he?
The goblin is almost unconscious, you can see that he's barely moving anymore.
I can't see.
Yeah. Well,
I'm in the hallway.
And the Gorong, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's as close as he can get. And, Yerith, you're stabilized, so there's no worries there.
I'm just standing still on my knees. Knock the fuck out.
Ringo!
Winks at Gorong! Deception!
Ringo, there's still one person who isn't up.
How many rolls can you still survive?
Well, Lucina could survive.
I need only one, and one succus. I'm okay.
And he needs two negatives,
three,
and he'll be bad.
Three failures. I need three failures.
Wait.
Or one critical and one normal failure.
Yeah.
There's still a good chance for Lucina to die if you don't help her.
Just kill the goblin.
I'm gonna kill the goblin.
Okay.
Kill the fucker.
By both, I guess.
16.
Yes. Yes, you get it with advantage because he's prone, so it hits automatically pretty much.
Oh yeah, okay.
And your firebolt engulfs the goblin and he's died. He's
okay,
dead.
And I'm gonna... I was standing here, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna sit on... Oh wait, I cannot sit on the same...
Nope.
I was gonna sit between. Okay, next.
Goblin is dead.
Now we still got that fucking bugbear to go down.
Yeah.
And almost everybody's fucking dead.
What language does Gorong speak?
Mickey, you can decide to shoot and run away if you want, of course.
What language does he speak?
The bugbear speaks common and goblin.
Okay. I speak to him in common and try and convince him to kill himself.
Wow!
You need to roleplay this really well then.
So
I can speak goblin. I should have. Yeah.
What should I roll?
You need to roleplay, and I will decide what you roll and what the difficulty is depending on how you roleplay it.
Gorong, I'll give you 15 gold pieces if you end your life right now.
Okay, persuasion difficulty 15.
Where's my persuasion?
Next to perception.
There we go.
No,
he doesn't take the offer. He just smiles at you. You think I'm stupid?
Am I still allowed to attack, or is that my action?
That speech is a free thing, so yeah, don't worry about it.
Right, I'm gonna fucking shoot it with my bow then.
Okay.
Your loss!
Hang on a second.
Yep.
Shut up.
Yep.
We're waiting, Mickey.
Come on, Mickey.
It hits.
Oh, it actually hit!
Oh shit, 8 and 5?
More!
Why did he
press it more?
No, it's only, no, it's only
8 damage only.
He clicked it.
So yeah, 8 damage on the Gorunk. He gets an arrow to his shoulder. Shoulder because he doesn't slow down from it.
So I'm gonna leg it.
Okay, you have your 6 shots.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Would you like to reconsider my offer?
Oh shit, I can see the light from here. I know where they are now.
1, 2, 3, 4. That's 4 slots if you go diagonally as well.
5, 6.
Okay, you gave it that 5 then. Good. Lucina! Roll for your life.
You're safe now, right?
Yep.
Okay,
yeah,
cool.
Yeah, we're all stabilized.
Okay, and let me try this again. Okay, gods from the heaven grant you one healing spell back.
Me?
Yeah.
But
and
I
you also get your consciousness back immediately.
Oh! So I got 1 hit point.
You get 1 hit point and you have 1 healing spell to spend on something.
Oh shit! Damn you!
Kill me. Cool.
Oh, hello!
One of the only guys
God
who's alive.
God has spoken.
Kill me.
God has spoken.
Hear me.
That's fucking...
Come on, Mercy isn't a heal bot. If you don't go to her, she cannot reach you. Isn't that what it goes?
Well... That's maybe can I use any action? And
you are still prone in the ground, so you I kind of need to get up first.
Yeah,
that'll take half of your movement.
But if he has a spell slot,
Ringo sees a holy light surrounding Lucina while she just gets her consciousness back and starts moving immediately. Primas,
oh shit.
Oh,
Eloris beat me. Good God. Well,
you have been given a second wind.
Second wind. Yeah. How's the Ringo looks like?
Ringo looks like he's taken a few.
Needing some healing. Or...
Not too much, no. But behind Ringo you can see Kilit and Sarah just lining the ground.
Ringo feels half-half about it.
Half-half about it? Describe half-half.
Well, fucking Sarah's on her back, knocked the fuck out. I'm on my knees, knocked out. I mean,
I have scratches, but like I can still walk.
Okay. Well, I gotta...
Again, me?
Saves yourself!
Sarah died 2 times. Died unconscious 2 times, so...
Save yourself.
3 times a charm!
So, okay.
I feel it is in a very majestic position there.
Yeah. And Sarah is more friendly. But... Friendly than Keith, more friendly. So...
When she has rage on, though.
More friendly when she has.
Actually, I do have still 1 rage. That's it.
Yeah. I gotta heal Sarah. I gotta heal Sarah, yeah.
Okay.
Do Sarah.
Girl on girl accent, let's go. Right now.
Okay, I'm gonna roll my initiative here.
Yes.
Did I get it
shit.
There? No, I didn't get it. Damn it.
Let me just...
I forgot. Yeah.
You forgot to... I'll just do it for you.
I'm gonna move here.
I can't see shit.
Get wrecked.
I can see the room on the other end, but I can't see the hallway at all.
Wait, if I... Oh yeah, yeah, right.
I have only lights or so.
Yeah. You kind of screwed without it. Oh, the light didn't even turn off while we were unconscious.
Yeah. Oh. Well, let's see.
Well, we cheated pretty
much. Concentration.
Yeah.
No.
Well, in that case, it stays on for that 1 hour, no matter what.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless you die, in that case, it immediately disappears.
Yo, the light can be colored as you like. Dude, red. Come on. Red light district.
Red light on Sarah.
Oh shit.
Spooky. Okay.
Drunk. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Dude, and I don't want to wish this is on stale. It's on stale. Civilization 6.
Kill it!
Delete.
You are still not stable, were you?
Nope.
Oh, wait, you are, because Rinko healed you.
Did he?
Yeah.
No.
No.
Yes, I did.
He's
got 1 hour for Kirith to get up. Well,
Yeah, exactly.
I thought you meant healed as in got my health back up.
Sarah!
No.
It takes you half your movement to get up. So
half my movement? Okay.
Yeah. Move.
I use half of it, so that's 15.
You see and, light from behind you as well, and noises.
I can see. Can you move me 3 squares to the hallway? I can't see.
Through the hallway.
Yeah. 3 squares. The other way.
This way.
The other hallway.
Thank you. And then I'll use my dash. Oh yeah, hold on. Thank you.
There's door ahead. It's just
2.
And 3. This is as far as I can go. Because it only doubles the amount you have at the moment when you use the dash.
It actually doubles my whole movement.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it doubles the whole movement. 3 more.
Yeah. But if you go too close, Garak might just decide to attack you.
Right now, I don't really care about that because...
you're raging.
Mickey is more likely to kill him.
I'm gonna get a sneak attack on him and everything, man.
Yeah, exactly. So, 1, 2, 3. She's just charging. Konoyaru! And she, with her Morningstar, scratches it on the wall while running through the room.
Onto the bars, that's clink, 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 clink.
Well, like that too.
Just throw the Morningstar at him.
Everyone in that room can hear that too. Sarah is just raging there. Clink, 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 clink.
Rage used. Thank you.
What is that? Okay, this is my turn.
There you go.
Okay, 1, 2. This is 2 turns. 3, 4, 5, 6. Wow.
Right in the darkness.
It's so dark. Wait, what can I do?
I can move you if you want to go forward. Wait,
I only have 6 moves.
Okay, so
you can use your dash if you want to move further.
I don't have a dash.
Everyone has a dash.
Everyone.
Running fast. Oh. And it's in your chance of attacking anything. You use an action to dash.
Okay. Oh, I use an action to dash.
Yeah.
Yeah.
At least you get closer to the fight.
I'm cozy here.
I'm cozy here, thank you.
Mickey!
Yes, so
he's still after you.
Is he still aggroed on me, yeah?
Yeah, and you see Sarah's just racing and coming and clearly ready to attack the bugbear.
Can I look at him and try and see how many healths he has left?
Which one? Gorunk or Sarah?
Yeah, Gorunk.
Well, he looks like he's taking a few hits, bleeding here and there, but he seems to be kind of fine still.
Now for fuck's sake. So I'm going to move 1, 2, 3...
Oh, shit. Oh, hello, Mickey.
4.
Let's make it a chicken race all around this whole place here.
Okay, I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna shoot at Ringo.
Ringo?
Yeah, Ringo.
Why not Garang?
Because Ringo is... Fine, I'll shoot at Sarah.
What? Really?
What?
Fine then, if you're gonna be fucking whine little bitches out here, I'll shoot at Garang.
I found the other 3! Some sort of a team!
Shoot at Grunk, 21.
No, oh, that hits immediately.
Or 9.
9. Oh. That one he failed! Now he's in pain and even more angrier than before. You can see that he's almost slowing down, but he's anger is keeping him up.
Adrenaline.
Really?
I am.
Badly
by the way.
Hurt.
Just gonna throw that there. Because I'm angry, charging angry.
Intimidation, let me see. Yeah, he's coming after you now.
Nice, man. Thank you.
Nice.
This man looks weaker.
I'm gonna see if I can remember any historical facts Banshee. About the cave.
The fuck?
While you're pondering about the history, let's see.
Yep, this is indeed a cave.
Actually, there is a little bit of history in this cave, and...
Oh,
let me see how much you know about it.
Yeah, you're all fucking laughing at me. Fuck you all.
This is the cave of the bugbear.
Name Goron.
Bug cave? Da-da-da-da.
The bugbear cave.
Where was the... I know there was something, I just need to find it, that's all.
Can you?
So...
Just make it up!
Okay, there we go. So apparently... There... was a dragon... this was used to be a dragon's cave. And you also notice that the shield Gorunk is using is actually a scale of a black dragon, which proves the fact that there used to be a dragon in this cave. And that's about all you know about it. This used to be a dragon's cave.
Mm.
A black dragon's cave.
Well, it's common knowledge that black dragons are very, very weak to water, so I'm going to throw my water skin at him.
You've already used your action, though, so...
Ah, shit.
And with my own home rules, black dragons are the worst ones possible. If you ever meet a live black dragon, if your soul isn't strong enough, everyone will forget about your existence. And
I'll get fucking wrecked.
You will most likely just disappear from everyone else's memories. That's what their aura does. It's kind of evil.
Two.
Black dragons are shit.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So yeah.
Bring it. Bring it, motherfucker.
Oh, why is oh yeah, Lucina's turn. Never mind.
Was is my turn. I think was.
It is after Mickey, it's your turn. Yeah, go ahead.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Heal me, I'm gonna die.
You don't
understand. How?
There's the character that looks the healthiest out of this all.
How? I barely life 2, so... 1, 2...
Use your medicine roll.
It's
you
not
see
here.
Lucina and coming, and Lucina looks like she's about to topple off from someone just sneezing at her. But she's ready for a fight.
Well. 1, 2, 3. No, I cannot hit her. Do I get covered in here?
Those are bars. You get 3/4 of cover if someone shoots at you.
Do I see any ranged weapons, Korug?
No.
Okay.
No, yes you do. He has a javelin.
Okay, I'm gonna stay here.
Gorunk charges right at Sara.
Yay!
And remember, he has a double hit die.
Yep, I know.
Well, damage die. He has to hit first.
Wow!
Holy shit!
Well, he hits!
Fucker!
And,
there goes Sara. Under four! Oh,
what?
Damage!
Are you
minus four!
Exactly! 4 damage on you.
Exactly. I've been very unlucky.
Oh, because you have rage, right?
Yeah, it's rage, so it's halved. But it's still 4, so he's still down.
He's still down. Wow.
Well done, Lucina. You see how useful it is to heal this little girl.
Yeah.
He's a punching bag.
Instead of the Tin Man, just kneeled down.
Well,
GG. That was fun.
Really?
That's my turn, right? One.
Yeah.
Oh wait,
yeah,
no, Saras.
Taren needs to do the saving throws again.
In before one.
Oh right. Yeah. Okay. Hold on, I need to
critical hit. Critical natural 20. Yeah. Oh shit! Almost.
Almost.
Oh. Only one. Okay,
one.
Sorry.
Two, three, four, five. Fuck, dude.
Distract him so I get a fucking sneak attack on him.
Let's just shoot the Gorang.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah, I'm gonna shoot. Oh, 14.
14, let's
oh,
see.
Oh fuck, I forgot to use inspiration again. God damn it, guys.
Well, it doesn't hit.
Remember,
it doesn't
hit. Your fireball just misses the Gorang. He blocks it with his Black Dragon Scale Shield and just bounces off.
Okay.
Mickey! You see people who are half dead. Sarah is down for the third count already. This is going real well for you guys.
Unlucky.
I blame the dice.
I'm going to tell Grunk that he has one more chance at my offer. I raise it to 20 gold.
He's really angry right now, so the difficulty would be 20 on persuasion. Go ahead and try.
Natural 20, let's go. No.
No. The last 15 would have worked this time, but no.
Fine, I'm going to shoot at him with a...
You managed to intimidate him with that offer. He still thinks that you're making fun of him, so...
Fuck's sake.
But shoot.
Yeah, I'll shoot at him with my bow. Bang.
No.
Oh,
he's so angry that he just moves his head a little bit and the arrow just misses him completely.
Wow.
Matrix moves.
Well, I'm gonna go... What?
Go to the top left, please.
Fuck off. 2, 5, 6. I can't do that. Fine, I'll just fucking leg it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, here. I'll go here.
Okay. Lucina! Gorank is still up, but he looks like he's about to topple over soon.
Sacred flame. Oh, also true damage.
If you do it from there, you're gonna hit the bars most likely because they are really thick.
It ignores cover.
Oh, God dang it, I keep forgetting about that. Okay. Oh, I forgot to close something here, just a second.
So you could say that it basically just comes out of thin air.
Yeah.
Okay.
Beam of light.
Or like above the
like
enemy.
Like Leona ult.
Oh.
It actually hits!
Yeah, your flame hits him on the hand and he snuffs it off quite quickly. Oh wait, that's too much.
And then I gonna back off. 1, 2, 3. Oh, 4, 5, 6.
Well, so Gorang sees that there's a robot on the direction where the flame appeared from.
Oh shit.
Rest in peace, Ringo.
She gonna hit me though. Can I not lie on the ground?
Yeah.
That does hit, I guess.
Rip.
Eight.
Unless you're right. Oh yeah, never mind. Never mind.
Wait, don't I have anything? No, I don't. I don't have any spell slots. Free!
Holy fucking shit!
his minimum is 4.
Yeah.
My HP is 4.
Minus 12.
That I'm minus 8.
How much do you have your maximum health?
8.
Oh.
I am. Did I get one shot?
Yep.
Yep. Ringo, your character just literally died.
Wow.
If you go to negative more or the same amount of your maximum life, you will immediately die.
Wow.
The Garang hits you,
watching, and we'll your chest,
and everyone can hear a big crack as your body just breaks.
God damn it! Holy shit!
Well.
Well, you are officially my first managed kill in any of my D&D games ever.
Oh, you tried so hard, you fucking finally succeeded! Oh man, rip Ringo. Of course it's Ringo who dies.
Fucking hell, dude.
At least it wasn't me.
You mean it's a shame it wasn't you?
Fuck off, man.
Sarah, roll for your life.
I'm gonna put my inspiration here. One and two.
Oh, thank God! God. You get one positive there.
Whew. Oh, wow. Thank God I used it.
Don't worry, Ringo. There might be help for you yet. So just don't leave the chat yet.
Anything is possible.
I wish to turn Ringo into spare parts and sell them.
Mickey!
Yes!
Gorong has noticed you again.
Oh, for fuck's sake! I'm gonna go... 1, 2, 3,
you cowardly chicken! You didn't run away from Gorong!
Fuck off! He just one-shot the robot! I'm gonna stay here, and I'm gonna shoot it in with my bow.
So... You hit it that far. Just...
Oh...
It's fine.
You angled him to me!
Yeah, it hits. Holy crap, those rolls, though.
Oh my god.
Your arrow hits Gorang, and finally he has lost his strength and topples down to the ground, dead.
Yay!
Oh, shit. Hey, we got two survivors!
Oh my god, oh,
Jesus. Two survivors.
Yeah,
only one dead.
Only one dead. So everyone else is surviving. Sarah is still kind of lying on the ground then.
Well, yeah, but we're knocked the fuck out. That's what I mean.
Oh, yeah, right.
So, yeah, Lucina hears how the bugbear's final roar of death appears and.
Yeah, I kind of hear. See. Ringos.
I need an engineer.
Sorry. I'm sorry. And go to Sarah. I'm gonna leg it over to the bugbear and loot him.
I like how everybody ditched just the unlikable paladin.
He's fine.
The bugbear. Actually, has three arrows on him because you've been shooting him a few times.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
And he also has his Morningstar, and that's about it.
I want his shield.
Oh yeah, that shield is actually a black dragon scale, and you value it about 50 gold pieces worth.
So can I just turn it into gold?
No. You will have to sell it first.
Yeah. So
find someone who wants a dragon scale.
Dragon scale.
Yeah. Go.
Fuck it, I'm leaving the Morning Star, but I'm taking the arrows, which puts me to about like 18 arrows.
Did you remember to take out an arrow every time you shot?
No.
So basically you're retrieving your own arrows back.
Yeah, but I've shot to other people as well. I'm also going to go and loot the corpse of Ringo. But nobody notices that because they're all dead.
I can't see.
Sarah. You can't see shit.
I can't throw the deception.
Lucina healed Sarah, including the time you looted the bugbear, so...
I'm still gonna... Fuck it then, I'm not even gonna bother. Fuck that.
And Sarah is stabilized, and you remember the prisoners? On the other room.
What? Who? I'm me?
No, the prisoners.
the prisoners.
Yeah, me.
In here.
Who see the prisoners? I didn't see any.
All being in the room, you see the cages. The cages are pretty much just here. They're invisible to the map, but they're still in here.
There's still shit to do, like, what the fuck is all this?
Okay. Holy shit, the whole map is now dark to me.
What's this shit? What is this?
Same for me.
Rinko, you can move your dead cock around to see around if you want.
I have little gears.
You're a flying dead body.
He's a ghost now.
You're a moving ghost.
No. I have little gears on the ground on my back, so I can just... If I'm on the ground, they just move and I can scroll on the ground.
Drop a gear.
Okay. So the prisoners in there. There's total of 12 prison people in there in a cage. And they are just thanking the Lord for you appearing here. Seeing that you are the ones that survived the fight.
I flirt with the prisoners.
Flirt! With the short sword.
What should I what should I roll? Flirt.
I think it's all about role playing.
Strength, charisma roll?
No, rolling is enough. You need to roleplay it as well.
There
are half scared prisoners in a cage. Stash
Come on.
Hey, you look proper fit in that cage, love.
You get thank yous for rescuing.
Fuck's sake.
Is Lucina or Mickey gonna open the cage though?
No, fuck off, I'm not opening the cage. While you're fucking about up there, I'm gonna loot Ringo.
I can open it.
Okay, you can open it. The 12th prisoner... Well, one of the prisoners actually says that he's also a follower of ex-guard, a cleric, and says that is there anyone she could maybe heal or look after. She's also able to do resurrection if it's needed.
Oh, okay, okay. So, there's...
I'd like to resurrect the bugbear.
No! I'm gonna assist. I'm gonna assist and... Let's revive that robot guy.
Us and you go do that. All the other prisoners are just slowly gathering themselves and trying to relax from being able to escape. And Mickey does not get to go adventuring too much. So, you go to where Sarah, Ringo is. Let's bring Ringo.
Ringo was here.
Yeah, Ringo is here. Where the heck?
Ringo was here.
Ringo is hiding in a corpse.
Holy shit, he's a ghost.
Oh god, please, I'm just clicking. So, Ringo is here now. You go to Ringo, she casts
super
expensive.
I got here.
Yeah. She casts this super expensive spell and says that this is the only time she can cast it in her whole life, but. Her life is safe thanks to you guys, so she will spend her specialty under this one robot guy who so gloriously and valorously helped her and the fellow prisoners. And Ringo, you get back to full health.
Oh shit!
And I shall remove your X.
I did it. Oh shit.
Do you have any words?
I'm gonna slap Lucina for aggroing that bugbear. What's the modifier? 1d4?
That?
Oh no, okay. It's 1d1. Was it 1d1 plus strength modifier or something?
It's.
Are you trying to get him unconscious?
No, I'm fine.
Okay.
I say.
Also, she helps stabilize in Kirith and Seraph in us that you are on one health.
Arigato.
Oh.
Can we stop myself?
So, Sarah and Kirith can now rise up and start moving around. Congratulations.
Yes!
Okay, so where do we go? I mean, what do we do? Did we loot everything? Mickey, give me back my stuff.
Fuck off, man. It's my stuff now. You don't know! You were dead, you fucking dick!
Well, no, I'm lighter, and you're the only one that would...
Also, the other prisoners! There was the prisoner that clearly looked like he could fight, and this one comes to talk with you. He tells that his name is Chab, and he is a gendarme agent who was captured investigating the cult activities in these caves.
The cult activities? What?
Cult. Cult activities.
Collar activities.
Border collars. And before it is a cave of smugglers and DVD and pirated copies.
All those nut 80s bad porn yeah. shit smuggled.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm gonna hail myself.
What else did he say?
Basically, the centering agent says that he has been investigating some strange happenings in the area. A black dragon lived here until recently, and it was parleying with humans for some reason. And the dragon hadn't been seen in a while, but humans were still skulking in the area, so Cobb decided to come and investigate the situation. He found that the dragon had been killed by adventurers, but the adventurers perished as well. Someone emptied the dragon's hoard and started harvesting parts of the dead dragon. This explains why the bugbear had the shield. Also, Cobb was trying to escape the lair and report the findings to when he was waylaid by dozens of goblins. Since then, the goblins have been in talks with humans to secure the area. He doesn't know more about the relationship, though. There are dozens, if not hundreds, of goblins living elsewhere in the lair. Their numbers are currently low because they were raiding the countryside. So if we don't leave this place soon, and the goblins return, their sheer number of goblins will be too much for you to fight. So there are literally hundreds of goblins returning within like an hour or two.
Okay.
And now is the good time to escape.
That's cool.
Let's get the fuck out of here.
Let's go.
I don't know what your problem is. It wasn't even that bad. Dude, I'm took like 2 damage. You're all a bunch of pussies.
Wait, Zara puts a torch on, I guess, so I'm gonna give you a
reward. I can't see!
There you go.
Thank you.
Why is Mickey O'Neill here? Oh.
Thank God.
He came out of the closet? No regrets on that one.
Okay.
You regret it when I fucking shove my shorts out up your ass.
So yeah, you managed to leave the place. The beatbox workers don't have much to offer in terms of reward, but Cobb gives you a handful of stashed gems worth 100 gold pieces for freeing him.
I think I get all of that because I did literally everything.
You did most of the work this time, actually, yeah.
For a change.
But how you share the gems is up to you.
I'll give 10 gold pieces worth also, of gems gives, to everybody else, but I'll keep the rest.
What?
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 It was Lucina who opened the cage, this, wasn't it? So, Chab is talking with Lucina.
Get fucked.
Okay. What?
So, basically you have a handful of gems that are worth 100 gold pieces. Let's say that there are 100 gems, so you can just share it like 1 gold piece per gem.
Yeah, he was the priest.
Hmm? The priest was one of the other prisoners.
I'm gonna give it the priest.
All of it?
All.
All 100 gold pieces?
Yep.
You fucking twat!
She thanks you very much and promises you that she will use the money to help the wounded and the weak on the city.
I attempt to pickpocket the priest.
No, you don't.
With over 14 people watching you.
I don't give a flying fuck.
No, you don't.
Okay.
Fuck off then. I changed my mind. I won't do it.
Okay.
You can't turn back on your word now.
Yes, I can. I fucking watch me.
And also he shows, tells that the shield that Korunk was using is actually the scale of a black dragon, which, by the way, Mickey is currently carrying. It's kind of a big shield so everyone can see it.
Yo, Can you not give that to Caleb?
Fuck off.
It's simply a regular shield. It's basically just a trophy that can be carried with pride.
Wait, Caleb,
it doesn't have any special effect.
Shield for 50 gold.
Yeah, you can sell it for 50 gold because it's a piece of dragon.
I just left my shield. Do I need another one?
Yeah, because this one's black dragon scale.
Yeah, it fits your soul, doesn't it?
So yeah, let me count the amount of experience you've gotten in this playthrough. Also, let's see.
Also,
Sarah, Mickey, Ringo, and Lucina, and every single one of you get an inspiration point.
I already have one.
Yeah, then you don't have a second one. But if you don't have an inspiration point, you get one now.
Who? Who get it?
Everyone.
Everybody except me.
Everybody.
Everyone.
Yay!
Nice!
And also,
yay.
Let me see. You killed 8 goblins. Let's see, goblins are 50 XP each, so I'm so bad with math sometimes. There's the calculator. So 50 times 8 is, that's 400 plus...
400?!
Wait, this will be shared between you also, don't worry about it.
Rip.
And that's plus another 200 there. And then the two wolves are... Let me check the numbers. 50, so that's another 100. And that's up to 5 people. You each get 140 experience.
Yes. 195, right? Total?
Well, 140 extra. So.
140.
Yeah, but we had 55, so it's 195 total.
Yep.
Normally, I would have to limit into 100 experience according to the story here, but I don't deal this stuff like that, so you get full 140 there.
Oh shit, dude! XP. I think one more day. If we have another 105 XP, then we got our level, right? It's 300.
Yep.
Four level. Nice.
You're closing in. Also, when you return back to the city, the Blackfish guard gives you 50 gold pieces to share with each other.
A what?
50 gold pieces for clearing the mission.
Oh yeah, right. Yo, we're with 5 people, so.
That's 10 for each.
Oh, shit.
10 gold for each.
What,
and also, Cobb gives you a potion of climbing.
Gliding?
Climbing.
Noob? Oh.
Climbing. Just climb a wall or something.
Ooh, spider potion.
Yeah. And
how many
also...
XP do we get?
What?
How many XP do we get? How many?
140 for each.
140.
That puts me on 205, yeah?
No.
195.
Well, it depends on how much experience you already have.
55.
Yeah, but we all have.
You should 55. All have the same amount.
Yep.
Yeah.
So. Yeah.
Yeah, 195.
Also. This gives you the chance if people want to join the Chentarim faction.
What?
Which one?
Chentarim, the evil kind of.
Oh, that one.
Oh, I'm joining that one. That one was cool.
Okay. So yeah, you talk with Chop and he invites you to join the faction. And Pancho, could you link the thing here again?
Did he post it?
Get. It's in the pinned messages.
Is it? No, it's not. It's not.
Pinned?
Factions.
It's a pinned one? It's this one?
Epic Worlds. Oh, it is! The fuck?
It is
pinned.
So yeah, In the bottom of this one, you can read about the center infection, and so as long as it opens up, thank you. I'm so glad when I get the new computer on. So you get a mark of their faction, and it is
cold coin.
It's a fake cold coin with a stamped symbol of the gender infection.
Oh, it's like one of that fits perfectly with Ornstein.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it does, and it fits perfectly with Mickey O'Neill.
Remember to mark it up so you have an insignia, which is a fake gold coin with the Centurion stamp symbol on it.
Wait, so...
And so, in overall, factions are just a way of getting mini-missions. But during these games, you are able to get a reputation towards your factions if you are in one or join one. But unless we go for any bigger campaigns, you don't really get any good advantages about being in a faction.
Mm.
So not yet. But it will be good to get this up and rolling if you're gonna play longer. It's basically a mission.
I don't want a job. I don't want to join.
Okay. The only one who wants to join is Mickey O'Neill. And of course, the gender infection, their goals are to amass wealth, look for opportunities to seize power, gain influence over important people and organizations, and dominate Faerun, which is this
way.
Of course, Mickey does this in private with Sharp, so no one else knows that he's joined the faction.
So withdraw your statement, Sarah.
Yeah. Delete it. They do this when, after you've returned back to the tavern and everything, he goes for a private chat with the character.
I'm gonna wink at Sarah.
Oh, I've accidentally clicked that on the top. Didn't know how long it's been there. There's just been a random dark spot in my stream for a while now.
Nice.
Good job.
Random what?
Random
I had
dark spot.
Overlay topped over by the Discord window for a while. So one third of it was covered by Discord.
Mm-hmm. My PC is dying, so I need to restart it. Is this over now? Is it all
done? This is pretty much over now, so yeah. After this, you all go back to the tavern, do whatever you want. If you want to go back shopping again with your new money, you feel free to do it. Just remember to inform me what you buy during this downtime.
Yes.
You get all of your health back to full, you get your spell slots back and so on, because it's going to be another week before you get another big mission.
Yes.
Okay, nice.
And
okay,
yeah,
that was about it.
Yo, guys, thanks.
Yep. It was good fun, guys.
It was good fun.
Wait a second. One thing. Ringo died, but did he get resurrected, or does he have to make a new
character?
Yes, he got
resurrected. I'm not as mad as I claim to be. I don't want people to die immediately on the second day.
Yeah, well, maybe it's okay for the noobs to actually have, like, a...
Yeah,
but
it's a noob protection.
In a way, I'm like, maybe I should make another character, a character that is like...
You're always like that, so it doesn't matter.
Because I feel like...
Maybe for the new campaign, once we're more accustomed to each other and everything.
Everyone always has the ability, if you want to retire your character and make a new one. But if you change your character to another one, you will start at the level you were before, but at zero experience towards the next level.
Oh.
So if you reset your character now, you will be back to zero experience.
Yeah,
if you reset at level 2, no matter how much experience you have, you will reset back to 300 experience and so on.
I see.
And you will not be able to use your retired character again, because it will turn into an NPC that I will be controlling in the future.
And before he becomes some kind of monster that you have to fight, some field boss or something.
Yeah.
It's
going to be a wardrobe
thing. I have
thing.
Plans like that in the future with that, okay?
That's going to be amazing.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Alright,
guys, I'm going to go take a shit. So, yep. I'll catch you guys later.
So, yeah, thank you for playing,
thank you.
Everyone.
Yo,
I hope you enjoyed it tonight.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not sure. I fell down
three times.
And you're still alive.
Yeah, and I got a fucking one shot pretty much. A half HP. Holy fucking shit, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm actually thinking, oh shit. By the way, I'm actually thinking of changing my my comprehend language spell. Can I do it right now?
When you get the level up, you are able to sense one spell, right?
Wait, like can that? I not? I heard
actually you learn two new spells.
Oh yeah. Oh. But whenever you have a long rest, you can switch it with some other spell that you know already.
Yeah, but aren't we having a long rest? I mean,
yeah, you can decide what spells you have prepared, of course.
Yeah.
But at the start of each session, you need to inform me the list of spells you have so that I know that you cannot cast anything else during that time unless you have a long rest.
Can I just say now?
That instead for the next game. For the next game. So, just at the beginning of the next game, you will give me a list of the spells you have prepared for the day.
Okay. Yeah, I still had the same.
I forgot about that because I'm not that used to playing with.
Oh, yeah. No, I still had the same three prepared. As before, but I was gonna throw down my comprehend languages and switch it over for mage armor.
Yeah, that's
so
a good choice.
So I will have 3 AC more. Hmm?
Yeah, that's a good choice.
What?
But yeah, it is a good choice, I said.
Oh, right.
But yeah, it is getting late for me, so I will be off here as well, and I'm guessing next Thursday. Same time, same place.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm fine.
Same place, my home. Okay. Sitting on a chair.
Bye, guys. I will turn you back to the. Oh, yeah. I could actually leave this goblin lair here so you can actually see it. So I'm gonna take the lights off. You can see the whole map now.
Oh, shit. Was there something on the bottom right?
No, that is, just goes deeper inside the caverns where the hundreds of goblins
are. Where the hundreds of goblins are, yeah, right. Yeah. What if we decided to go in?
If you had gone in there, I would have had to just mark you dead because there would have been just as many goblins coming back in here.
Okay. Was there anything we forgot to pick up? As in, you know, maybe hidden treasures around, like, the top right or something? I'm not sure if we planned anything up there.
Nah, you actually found everything there was in this place.
Oh, nice.
And the only extra thing you didn't see earlier was my smiley face up here because I drew it on.
Yeah.
While I was waiting for you people to do stuff. I'm gonna leave this map on, so we'll continue on getting to the tavern next time.
Yes.
Wait, okay. I want that dragon scale. Give me my dragon scale, Ornstein.
Yeah.
He already left, I think.
No, he's in the chat back. Now. He's back.
Okay. So yeah, at this point, I'm gonna just thank my chat next, so.
Yo.
Bye.
See you later, guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
So yeah, thank you everyone for watching the stream.